sa inyong lahat. Bihira po tayo makasaksi ng panahon kung saan ang mundo ay nababaliktad tulad ng nararanasan natin ngayon. Imbes na ang mga kriminal ang mga kinukulong o pinapanatili sa kulungan, sila ang pilit na pinapawalang sala at inaabswelto pagkatapos na silang hatulan bilang mga kriminal ng ating mga hukuman. Ang mga inosente naman na hindi dumaan sa paglilitis ay pinapaslang at iniiwang nakabulagta sa mga lansangan o di kaya ay sinasampahan ng mga kasong gawa-gawa lamang para sa paghihiganti at sa layuning patahimikin ang mga sumisigaw ng katarungan. Kamangha-mangha nga naman ang takbo ng katarungan sa mga panahong ito. Ito po ay kakaibang dimensyon ng realidad. Ito po ang kagilag-gilalas na mundo sa loob ng pambihirang utak ni Pangulong Duterte. Noong nakaraang Biyernes, sinampahan ako ng kasong paglabag sa Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act ng DOJ sa ilalim ni Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre sa Regional Trial Court ng Muntinlupa habang ang nahatulang kidnapper at nasasakdal na reyna ng PDAF na si Janet Lim Napoles ay nais na ipawalang sala ni Solicitor General Jose Calida sa Court of Appeals. Sa kasong isinampa sa Regional Trial Court, inaabswelto din ng DOJ ang mga drug lords na binantaan noon ng mismong Pangulong Duterte na huwag lumabas ng bilibid kung gusto pa nilang mabuhay. Ito ay gantimpala nila bilang kapalit ng pagtestigo laban sa akin. Kung noon ay pinagbabantaan sila ng kamatayan ng Pangulo, sila ngayon ay binigyan ng mararangyang pribilehiyo ayon na rin sa mga dokumentong na ilabas sa media. Ang Pangulo na galit daw sa droga at sa mga drug lords ang siya ngayong nag-aalaga at nag-aabswelto sa mga drug lords na ito. Sa kabilang dako naman, sinasabi ng rehimeng ito na walang kasalanan si Janet Lim Napoles. Katarungan raw para kay Janet Lim Napoles ang mapawalang sala sa sakdal na pagkidnap kay Benhur Luy at nang tuluyan na siyang makalaya sa bilangguan. Ayon kay Solicitor General Calida, si Laila De Lima na naman daw ang may kasalanan kung bakit nakulong ang walang salang si Janet Lim Napoles. Pagkakasala ko raw ang usigin sa korte at maipakulong ang inosente at walang salang si Janet Lim Napoles. Ito po ang makasaysayang pambabaligtad ng mundo sa ilalim ng rehimeng Duterte, kung saan ang mga ahensya ng gobyerno ay nagtutulong-tulong upang iabswelto at mapalaya ang mga nahatulang kriminal at kinakasuhan naman ng mga nagpursiging ng huli at nagsakdal sa kanila gamit din ang mga bilanggong kriminal na drug lords na inaabswelto naman bilang mga testigo. Sa nakaraang linggo, marami na sa atin ang nadadagdagan ng buhok sa bumbunan dahil sa kakataas ng kilay o di kaya ay nakalbo naman dahil sa kakasabunot sa buhok. Hindi na tayo dapat magtaka. Excuse me. Kung nagawa ng isang pangulo ang magsulong ng isang polisiya na pagpatay sa mga maralita na pinaghihinalaan lamang na gumagamit ng droga, ano pa ang makakapagpigil sa kanya na gawin ang lahat anong naisi niya? Ang iabswelto ang mga totoong drug lords, ang ipawalang sala ang kidnapper at reyna ng PDAF, ang gawan ng kwento at taniman ng ebidensya ang mga kalaban, na inamin din naman niya ang gawain niya noong piskal pa siya, at patuloy na pumatay pa ng marami pang mga maralita dahil trip lang niya. Alam na natin ngayon na walang batayang prinsipyo ang lahat ng mga aksyon ng ating Pangulo. Basta trip lang niya, gagawin niya. Hindi dahil tama o mali, kung hindi dahil kaya niyang gawin at hinahayaan lamang natin siya na gawin ito. Ang tawag dito ay kawalan ng pakundangan. Ano man ang gawin niya, tiwala siyang ligtas siya sa parusa o pananagutan. Sa salitang Ingles, impunity. Trip lang niya. Yan po ang klase ng pamamahala ni Pangulong Duterte. Nag-umpisa ito noong nadiskubre niya bilang mayor ng Davao City na maaari naman palang pumatay ng daan-daang katao ng walang pakundangan at ng walang pananagutan. Sa katotohanan, hanggang ngayon ay wala pa siyang pinagbabayaran sa ilalim ng batas kahit isa man lang sa mahigit 1,000 sa Davao at 7,000 sa buong Pilipinas na kanyang pinapatay sa kanyang mga death squad at mga alamis. Pero ngayon ay baka maari na siyang panagutin sa kanyang mga karumaldumal na mga krimen. Kahapon ng umaga, nasaksihan niyo lahat, lumantad na ang kanang kamay ni Pangulong Duterte sa Davao Death Squad, si SP03 Arturo Las Cañas. Katulad din ni Edgar Matubato, nagsagawa siya ng public confession tungkol sa mga pagpatay ng ginawa nila sa Davao Death Squad sa utos mismo ni Pangulong Duterte. Silang dalawa ni SP04 Sanson Sunny Benaventura ang mga utak at kamay ni Pangulong Duterte sa anumang operasyon ng Davao Death Squad. Sa paglantad ni Las Cañas, wala na pong natitirang duda ng atin pong Pangulo ay isang mamamatay tao at sociopathic serial killer. Ito na rin po ang dahilan kung bakit natin nararanasan ang lahat ng kahibangan sa gobyerno sa ilalim ng rehimeng ito na pinangungunahan ng numero unong kriminal sa buong Pilipinas, kung hindi man sa buong mundo, walang iba kung hindi si Pangulong Rodrigo Roa Duterte. Huwag na rin tayo magtanong, katulad ng sinabi ni Senadora Risa Hontiveros, kung bakit mistulang may reunion ng mga questionableng karakter sa ilalim ng rehimeng Duterte. Mula sa mga Marcos kay Arroyo hanggang kay Napoles, 10 ng kanilang mga abogado katulad ni Ferdinand Topacio at mga operator na katulad nila Dante Jimenez, Sandra Cam, Reynaldo Esmeralda at Ruel Lasala. Andyan din ang mga pangunahing enforcers ng mga utos ni Pangulong Duterte, sila Secretary Aguirre at Soljen Kalida na mga abusado at aroganteng opisyal sa ating pamahalaan. Huwag na tayong magtanong kung bakit sa panahon ni Duterte naglabasan at namayagpag ang lahat ng mga kriminal, korap, halang, bituka at maiitim ang kaluluwa. May reunion ng mga kriminal sa gobyernong ito dahil ang pinakakriminal sa kanila ngayon ang Pangulo ng bansa. Parang sa pelikula lang yan ni Batman, kung saan pinatawag ni Joker lahat ng masasamang loob sa Gotham City upang maghasik ng kadiliman. Kumbaga sa pelikula, si Pangulong Duterte po si Joker sa eksenang pinapanood natin sa kasalukuyan. Isang psychotic na mamamatay tao at pinaka-leader ng lahat ng mga halangang bituka mula pa noong panahon ni Marcos hanggang sa panahon ni Arroyo. Maitim ang pakay ng rehimeng ito. Ang gamitin akong halimbawa para takutin, paatrasin at patahimikin ang kanilang mga kritiko, ilihis ang atensyon ng publiko sa patuloy nilang pagmamalabis at kapalpakan, at para na rin pagtakpan ang madugong kampanya laban sa droga. Ang bilang ng mga pinatay nitong nakalipas na 7 buwan ay mas marami na kaysa sa mga pinatay sa 14 na taon ng batas militar at rehimeng Marcos. Mahigit 7,000 sa 7 buwan, 1,000 kada buwan. Malinaw din ang kanilang layunin. Sa gitna ng kampanyang pagpatay sa mga maralita at maliliit na pusher at user, nais nilang sirain ang kredibilidad ng mga nagtataguyod sa karapatang pantao. Laban sa akin, ito ay kanilang isinasakatuparan sa pamamagitan ng pagdawit sa akin sa droga at pagyurak sa aking pagkababae. Bilang pangunahing boses sa Senado, kailangan akong patahimikin ng rehimen upang wala nang tumuligsa sa kampanya nitong pagpatay sa mga maralita at dukha. Ilang beses na akong halos mawalan ng loob sa gitna ng paggamit ng buong makinarya ng gobyerno laban sa akin. Kayo na rin ang naging saksi sa 7 buwan na pakikipaglaban at kahihiyan na aking dinaanan. Nakita naman ninyo kung paano tayo lumaban. Mag-isa man o sa bandang huli, kasama na rin ng mga iba pa nating kababayan sa akademya, sa simbahan, pati na sa gobyerno, at lalong-lalo na mula sa mga maralitang komunidad. Lumaban ako dahil alam kong hindi magtatagal ang pananahimik. Lumaban ako dahil alam kong hindi habang panahon ay ako lamang ang lumalaban. Lumaban ako hanggang dumami na tayo. Lumaban ako hanggang hindi na ako nag-iisa. Hinding-hindi ako aatras sa laban, kahit saan pang korte nila isampa ang mga inimbentong kaso sa akin, kahit mali-mali ang bintang at pinagsampahan na husgado. Hinding-hindi ako aatras sa laban, ngayon pang alam kong hindi na ako nag-iisa. Maraming na po tayo, kaya matakot na po sila. Nananawagan po ako ngayon sa lahat ng ating mga kababayan na hindi pa kumikilos upang panagutin ang mamamatay tao na pangulo ng bansa. Sa Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption o VACC na nagsampa sa akin ng kasong kriminal, kailan nyo isasampa ang pinakamalaking kasong kriminal sa kasaysayan ng ating bansa kung saan libo-libo ang iniutos na ipapatay ni Ginoong Duterte bilang mayor ng Davao at ngayon Pangulo ng Pilipinas? Huwag sanang maging balakid sa pagharap ninyo sa hamong ito ang inyong may pinipiling pagkakaso at pag-aabogado sa inyo ng abogado ng mga drug lords ng Bilibid at ni Ginang Arroyo na si Attorney Topacio. Sa mga miyembro ng kabinete ni Pangulong Duterte, maaari niyong isalba ang bansang ito mula sa isang kriminal na pangulo sa pamamagitan ng pagdeklara na dahil sa kanyang kriminal na pag-iisip ay wala siyang kakayahan na gampanan ang mga katungkulan ng isang pangulo. Sa Integrated Bar of the Philippines at sa mga abogado, ang paghahari ng batas at hustisya ang tanyag na katangian ng propesyon na inyong kinakatawan. Sa harap ng pinakamalaking kaso ng pagyurak sa batas at paglapastangan sa katarungan, kailan ba natin haharapin ang hamong ito bilang mga manananggol ng katwiran at katotohanan? Sa mga kawani ng gobyerno, kasama na ang kapulisan at kasundaluhan, alam ko pong mahirap ang dinadaanan ng mga katulad ninyong profesional sa ating serbisyo sibil kung paano manatiling tapat sa tungkulin sa gitna ng kahibangan ng inyong liderato. Ang hamon sa inyo ay ang manatiling tagapaglingkod ng mamamayan at tagapaghatid ng serbisyo, kapusman at kulang ang pinaglaanan dahil na rin sa kawalan ng moral ascendancy ng mga namumuno ngayon. Sa ating mga kababayan na pinili na tumabi muna at patuloy na manood lamang sa daloy ng ating kasaysayan, alalahanin natin ang mga katangian ng ating lahi. Lahi tayo ng mga bayani. Ngayon, higit kailanman ay kailangan ng ating bayan ang inyong tapang at kadakilaan. Mahigit 3 dekada na ang nakalipas mula nung huli nating ipakita sa sarili natin at sa buong mundo sa lansangan ng EDSA na kahit sa pamamong batang ng diktadura ay walang pinakbat laban sa pinagkaisang lakas at layunin ng sambayanan. Ngayon ay panahon na naman upang tayo ay manindigan at tumayo sa harap ng isa pang kriminal na diktador at rehimeng mapaniil. Ipaglaban po natin ang ating mga karapatan. Ipaglaban natin ang hustisya. Ipaglaban natin ang demokrasya. Maraming salamat po. I think padating naman po siya, isa po sa aking mga abogado, mga volunteer lawyers, si Attorney Alex Padilla. Kaya lang nagkaroon na ata siya ng live studio interview. para kung meron pong mga katanungan sa legal aspects ng mga kaso na ng mga kaso na sinampa sa akin at ng mga pleadings na final ho nila kahapon pagkatapos po ng raffle ay siya po ang sasagot. Ito po yung mga final nila. Motion to quash sa criminal case number 165. Another motion to quash doon sa isang kaso, criminal case number 167. At doon naman po sa isa, omnibus motion to quash for judicial determination of probable cause and to hold in abeyance issuance of warrant of arrest. Lahat po dito sa lahat pong motions na itong final for each of the court kung saan na raffle po yung tatlong kaso, I may prayer to defer first the issuance of the warrant of arrest pending the resolution of the issues raised, particularly jurisdictional issue. Yes. Opo. I was informed that these cases have been set for hearing sabay-sabay nga daw ho sa Biyernes before these three branches of RTC Muntinlupa. No. Well, dito po sa dalawang kaso, ang pangunahin dito na issue is the issue of jurisdiction. Yung motion to quash, pinapa-quash, in other words, pinapa-dismiss yung kaso kasi hindi po tamang forum yung RTC or yung regular court, kundi ombudsman and eventually Sandigan Bayan if and when the ombudsman finds probable cause. Yun po ang pangunahing issue dito sa motion to quash. So if the courts agree that indeed wala silang jurisdiction, kundi ombudsman and Sandigan Bayan, then ang mangyayari, i-dismiss po nila ang mga kaso at siguro kung hindi na-questionin ng DOJ o ng mga complainants, ay doon na lang nila ipa-file sa ombudsman yung mga kaso. Yung isa naman po, jurisdictional din po, pero meron din judicial determination of probable cause kasi itong kaso na ito, yung isang kaso, ay yung period na sinasabi dito ay March 2016 na hindi na po ako Secretary of Justice noon. Pero katulad din po nung dalawang cases, sa tingin ho namin, wala hong basehan, wala ho talagang batayan itong mga kaso na ito on the probable cause issue. Theoretically, procedurally, and legally, hindi ho muna dapat sila mag-issue ng warrant of arrest. Dahil precisely, kailangan muna nilang dinggin at pag-aralan yung mga grounds na nakasaad dito sa mga pleadings na ito, particularly the issue of jurisdiction dito sa mga motions to quash. That should be the correct rule. Masyado naman pong hindi tama yun kung bigla na lang silang mag-i-issue ng warrant of arrest even before holding or conducting the hearings.
But if everything fine on Friday, kung mali po under jurisdiction nila, that doesn't also mean na warrant
agad. Hindi rin ko kagad. Kasi even if, let's say, sasabihin nila, hindi, may jurisdiction kami, RTC, they still have to also, again, determine whether in fact merong probable cause. Yes. I said it before na I actually rely now on the judiciary, on the sense of independence, objectivity, impartiality, fairness, and judiciousness of the courts as an independent branch of government, unlike the DOJ, which is directly under the executive department na ang kanilang pinuno, yung pangulo mismo at ang kanyang alter ego na si Secretary Aguirre ay matagal nang nagkaroon ng prejudgment laban sa akin. Kaya hindi na po nakakagulat yung so-called finding of probable cause nila.
Mm-hmm.
Hintayin muna po natin ang magiging action ng Regional Trial Court. Kasi nga ho, meron tayong exhaustion, the principle of exhaustion of remedies. And we still have an available remedy, and that is the motions that we filed, the motions to quash and the motions for judicial determination of probable cause. And therefore, hintayin muna ho namin ang magiging resolution, depende po sa magiging aksyon. Kung adverse po sa akin, kung i-deny po nila ang motions to quash and motions for judicial determination of probable cause, then we will avail of the proper remedy, which is going up to the proper court, either the Court of Appeals at pwede rin diretso po sa Supreme Court. Yes, yes. Yes, definitely. Sinabi na rin po. In fact, si Attorney Chel Diocno and even Attorney Alex Padilla, they are volunteer lawyers. Si Attorney Chel Diocno nga po, siya po nag-handle ng aking petition for habeas data, which is still pending with the Supreme Court against the President. And then si Attorney Alex Padilla naman po, nag-volunteer din po siya for purposes of the criminal cases. Nagkataon lang po na because they are part of the flag and they're the ones apparently na nag-handle ngayon kay SPO 3 Las Cañas. Kasi nasabi ko na rin po sa inyo kahapon, hindi ko po alam yun na lalabas o lalantad na si SPO 3 Las Cañas. Si Senator Sonny Trillanes po ang nakakaalam, and kahapon nga po sinabi ko sa inyo, nagulat nga po ako na si Las Cañas pala yung pasabog kahapon. And it's just a coincidence na sila attorney sila Dean Chel Diocno as part of the flag ang nag-aano ngayon, nag-handle kay SPO 3 Las Cañas. So coincidence lang po 'yon. Thank you. Andiyan na naman sila. Wala, ni-spin na naman nila. Ang hilig-hilig nila sa mga ganyan na mga since nahihirapan siguro sila kung paano na naman nila yan i-handle itong napakalaking expose yung nalaman natin, napakundin natin si SPO 3 Las Cañas. And to think na my information is that marami pa na alam sa SPO 3 Las Cañas. Parang samples lang yung mga sinight niya ng mga incidents kahapon, katulad nung bombing ng mosque, yung kay June Pala and a few others. Na remember, yung mga yon, isa rin, yun din ang mga kasama dun sa naging testimonya ni Cesar, ni Edgar Matobato. So ano na ngayon, mga sasabihin ng mga iba dyan? Myth pa rin ba ang DDS? Chismis lang ba ang DDS? Uncorroborated ba ang testimony ni Edgar Matobato pagkatapos na linait-lait siya nung nag-appear siya sa Senate? Kayo na ho ang maghusga. Thank you. Alam niyo po, with due respect to those who have a contrary opinion, kasi syempre, mga ganyang issues, hindi madaling issue yan. Pagdedebatehan talaga yan. Hati ang mga opinion, even among legal luminaries, about whether or not these things about President Duterte are covered by presidential immunity. Kasi kaya ako china-challenge ko yung principle na yan of presidential immunity dun sa kaso na sinampak ko sa Supreme Court, yung petition for habeas data. Nang pangunahing argumento ko po doon, hindi po sakop ng trabaho ng isang pangulo na nambabastos siya sa isang babae na katulad ko sa sobrang pagyuyurak ng aking pagkababae, sa pag-violate ng right to privacy ko. Yun po ang ano ko doon. And that is an open case. It's still an unresolved case. It's a novel issue. Ito rin po, itong revelation na ito, na siya pala ay isang psychopathic serial killer, mass murderer. Covered kaya po ito ng presidential immunity? I don't think so. I don't think that those who crafted the principle of presidential immunity, kasi wala naman actually yan sa constitution natin. We just followed it from the US, American legal system. I don't think they have foreseen a situation na merong pangulo na ganyan. na hindi na ho yun ano. Kasi ano, kasi the underlying rationale for the doctrine is para hindi na di-distract ang trabaho ng isang pangulo if you allow just any case to be filed against him. You know, yung mga, it's just contemplating mga minor cases, mga purely harassment cases, vexatious suits or cases. But I don't think they have comprehended itong sitwasyon natin ngayon sa kabila ng mga nangyayari ngayon at dyan sa expose na yan na siya pala talaga ho ang behind the Davao Death Squad na ginaya nila yung estilo na yon, yung polisiya na yon sa Davao dito sa bansa natin, sa buong Pilipinas, kaya meron tayo daily cases of EJ case. Yes, I don't think that the doctrine of presidential immunity applies under the current context. This can certainly be a basis for impeachment. High crimes, other high crimes. Some would say, some lawyers, some legal luminaries would say, but the acts being imputed to the president are those that were committed while he was still mayor. But remember, yes, sa DDS, as mayor. Pero, yung mga killings ngayon, na DDS style, pangulo na po siya. These are murders, extrajudicial killings, mass murders, crimes against humanity. In other words, high crimes. One of the grounds for impeachment, aside from culpable violation of the Constitution, is other high crimes. Wala naman po atang duda na yung mga ganyan partake of high crimes.
Some of you had numbers in lower house.
Oh. Pardon?
Ma'am, do you have numbers in lower house?
I wouldn't know. Ganito ho, alam ko ho na may mga ilan-ilan din ng mga mambabatas at kapwa senador na ganun ang sinasabi. Kasuhan sila Scanias ng perjury. Ang tanong ko po, ano ba ang importante para sa atin? Malaman yung buong katotohanan o kasuhan lang yung mga ganyan na mga, you know, somehow they have been stricken by their conscience. Nakita niyo naman yun, the way SPO3 Las Cañas was narrating yesterday. He was stricken by conscience, public confession. Yung daw ang panatan niya sa Diyos, nasasabihin na niya ang totoo. Gawa nga, inuusik siya ng kanyang konsyensya, lalo na yung pagpatay mismo ng dalawa niyang kapatid. Ano ho bang importante sa atin? Di ho ba katotohanan? Anyway, wala na namang pakialam yan sila Edgar Matubato and si Las Cañas. Na kahit ano na daw mangyari sa kanya, sa kanila, kahit patayin na sila, sila na mismo nagsasabi niyan, ay sasabihin pa rin nila yung alam nila. Yun ang pinaka-importante po, katotohanan. Yes. That's not my call. Ang ano ko po sa kanila, for example, sa kabinete, kasi meron naman ng constitutional provision under Article 7 of the 1987 Constitution that by a majority of the members of the cabinet, they can actually make a declaration that the president is incapable of performing his functions. Nakasabi ho doon, incapacity to perform his duties and functions. It's a broad term. Incapacity, permanent or temporary, physical or mental. And I think physical and mental incapacity applies to the specific situation of our president. There have been a lot of talk issues about the state of the physical health of the president now. In fact, it's very sensitive about it. Why don't they disclose the real state of health, physical health of the president? Tapos itong mga disclosures na ito, this goes into the mental health of the president. Now you have a president with a criminal mind. To IBP and the lawyers, kasi napapansin ko po, mukhang malabnaw palagi ang mga nagiging reaction nila. They should be more proactive. Tulungan po nila yung mga pamilya ng mga biktima ng EJ case. Wag mo nilang ipaubaya lang sa mga groups like FLAG. We are fortunate enough na may grupo katulad ng FLAG na umaasikaso ng mga usapin na yan, ng mga kaso na yan of EJ case. But I'm appealing to the professional organizations, to the lawyers, to the IBP. Lend a hand in terms of exacting justice and accountability. Yes. Ang panawagan ko lang naman po sa mga sa publiko is yung mga kasi karamihan mo sa atin tahimik pa rin. Huwag naman ho kayong manahimik. Yung lend your voice of outrage of what's happening in the country. Sabi nga ho ni Father Robert Reyes is there is also, aside from evil of impunity, there is also evil of silence going on. I don't want to be.
Ito yung MRO ni Senadora De Lima, papasok sa kanyang opisina ngayon. At inaasahan na magbibigay ng payak.
But ang ano ko lang naman dito is sana magising na po ang ating mga kababayan. Yung mga nagtutunog-tunogan lang o yung mga
Ayan nga, at pumasok na yung MRO ni Senator De Lima.
Let's not be indifferent sa mga nangyayari. They're okay. They have prepared also themselves psychologically and emotionally about any situation. The worst scenario, like arrest and detention. It's very difficult, definitely. On my part, personally, and on the part of my family, my friends, my staff. But it is something that I'm really willing to face, to confront. I will continue fighting. Nandito po si Attorney Padilla. So kung meron pa hong mga ibang tanong tungkol sa kaso, I think you'll be open to questions. Kung wala na po, marami pong salamat sa inyo.
Ang ibig sabihin ng MRO is yung Media Relations Officer. So yun yung tumatanggap at nagbibigay ng mga media informasyon at media kits pagkatapos ng hearing kung saan dumadalo si Senadora De Lima. So yun yung siya yung pumasok kanina. At inaasahan nga natin na anumang oras o anumang minuto mula ngayon ay magpapalabas ng payag dito si Senadora De Lima sa harap mismo ng kanyang tanggapan sa 5th floor ng Senate Building. Itong Room 502. At marami nga, puno yung mga media dito, lahat international and local media. At patuloy natin ngayon na tabayanan yung kung ano yung magiging mangyayari sa pag-usad nga ng pagsasampa ng arrest warrant kay Senadora De Lima ngayong hapon.
Ito po ay kakaibang dimensyon ng realidad. Ito po ang kagilag-gilalas na mundo sa loob ng pambihirang utak ni Pangulong Duterte. Noong nakaraang Biyernes, sinampahan ako ng kasong paglabag sa Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act ng DOJ sa ilalim ni Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre sa Regional Trial Court ng Muntinlupa habang ang nahatulang kidnapper at nasasakdal na reyna ng PIDA na si Janet Lim Napoles ay nais na ipawalang sala ni Solicitor General Jose Calum.
Nakain daw muna yung mga tao sa loob.
Sa kaso inaabswelto din ng DOJ ang mga drug lords na binantaan noon ng mismong Pangulong Duterte.
Inaasahan na masinsin ng talakayan ang inaasahan natin sa loob ng opisina ni Senadora De Lima.
Ito ay gantimpala nila bilang kapalit ng pagtestigo laban sa akin. Kung noon ay pinagbabantaan sila ng kamatayan ng Pangulo, sila ngayon ay binigyan ng mararangyang pribilehiyo ayon na rin sa mga dokumentong na ilabas sa media. Ang Pangulo na galit daw sa droga at sa mga drug lords ang siya ngayong nag-aalaga at nag-aabswelto sa mga drug lords na ito. Sa kabilang dako naman, sinasabi ng rehimeng ito na walang kasalanan si Janet Lim Napoles Katarungan raw, raw para, para kay Janet Lim Napoles ang mapawalang sala sa sakdal na pagkidnap kay Benhur Luy at nang tuluyan na siyang makalaya sa bilangguan. Ayon kay Solicitor General Kalida, si Laila De Lima na naman daw ang may kasalanan kung bakit nakulong ang walang salang si Janet Lim Napoles. Pagkakasala ko raw ang usigin sa korte at maipakulong ang inosente at walang salang si Janet Lim Napoles. Ito po ang makasaysayang pambabaliktad ng mundo sa ilalim ng Rehimeng Duterte, kung saan ang mga ahensya ng gobyerno ay nagtutulong-tulong upang iabsuelto at mapalaya ang mga nahatulang kriminal at kinakasuhan naman ng mga nagpursiging ng huli at nagsakdal sa kanila gamit din ang mga bilanggong kriminal na drug lords na inaabsuelto naman bilang mga testigo. Sa nakaraang linggo, marami na sa atin ang nadadagdagan ng buhok sa bumbunan dahil sa kakataas ng kilay o di kaya ay nakalbo naman dahil sa kakasapunot sa buhok. Hindi na tayo dapat magtaka kung nagawa ng isang pangulo ang magsulong ng isang polisiya na pagpatay sa mga maralita na pinaghihinalaan lamang na gumagamit ng droga. Ano pa ang makakapagpigil sa kanya na gawin ang lahat anong naisin niya? Ang iabsuelto ang mga totoong drug lords, ang ipawalang sala ang kidnapper at reyna ng PDAF, ang gawan ng kwento at taniman ng ebidensya ang mga kalaban, na inamin din naman niya ang gawain niya noong piskal pa siya, at patuloy na pumatay pa ng marami pang mga maralita dahil trip lang niya. Alam na natin ngayon na walang batayang prinsipyo ang lahat ng mga aksyon ng ating Pangulo. Basta trip lang niya, gagawin niya. Hindi dahil tama o mali, kung hindi dahil kaya niyang gawin at hinahayaan lamang natin siya na gawin ito. Ang tawag dito ay kawalan ng pakundangan. Anuman ang gawin niya, tiwala siyang ligtas siya sa parusa o pananagutan. Sa salitang Ingles, impunity. Trip lang niya. Yan po ang klase ng pamamahala ni Pangulong Duterte. Nag-umpisa ito noong nadiskubre niya.
Sa mga oras na ito ay wala pa rin paggalaw sa lahat ng mga nakaantabay sa labas ng opisina ni Senadora De Lima ngayong hapon. At tiniyak naman nga ng kampo nito ngayon na hindi niya tatakasan ang kanyang asunto at reklamong kinakarap kaugnay nga sa tatlong kaso nito ni Senador De Lima sa Muntinlupa RTC. So nasa loob yung ilan sa mga abogado ng senadora at masinsinan siguro yung gagawin nilang usapan sa loob. Inaasahan kasi ng kampo ni Senadora De Lima na madidelay yung paglalabas ng arrest warrant na niya ngayong linggo kasi nga nag-file siya ng tatlong motion to quash sa tatlong kasong kanyang kinakaharap sa Muntinlupa RTC. Pero suddenly, hindi nila inaasahan na ngayong hapon ay naglabas nga ng arrest warrant at sinabi din ni Senador SOJ Aguirre, Secretary of Justice Aguirre, na posibleng magpalabas ng arrest warrant ang CIDG in accordance sa citing insedition na nangyari nga kasi yung mga pahayag ni Senadora De Lima noong nakarang araw sa kanyang press conference na tinawag niya na killer itong si Pangulong Duterte. So patuloy pa rin ang ating pag-antabay sa mga kaganapan dito mismo sa harap ng Room 502 kung saan nasa loob si Senadora jail? De Lima.
Inside of jail. And it... What's way late? We heard, it is alleged, that the judge who issued the warrant of arrest had just arrived.
Sinabi naman kanina ng mga kapanayam, itong si Secretary of Justice Aguirre, anumang araw o anumang oras ngayong araw, pag naisilbi o posibleng maisilbi yung arrest warrant,
ni Senator De Lima. So walang magiging hadlang kasi nga di ba may mga argumento din na baka after office hours o hindi na pwedeng arestuhin si Senator De Lima. Pero ayon naman sa pahayag ni Senate President Coco Pimentel, hindi pwedeng arestuhin si Senator De Lima sa loob mismo ng Senate Halls. Kapag ito ay nakalabas, saka pa lamang ito o saka pa lamang niya matatanggap o ihahain sa kanya yung kanyang pending warrant of arrest. So inaasahan nga natin paglabas ni Senadora De Lima sa kanyang opisina, magbibigay ito ng kanyang huling salaysay o posibleng huling salaysay na din yan at ma-serve na rin yung kanyang arrest warrant ngayong hapon na ito. So ito na yung pinakihintay ng mga nagsampa ng kaso. Maalala natin, nagsampa ng kaso yung DACC sa kanya at marami pang nagsampa ng kaso kay Senadora De Lima kaugnay nga sa paglaganap ng illegal na droga sa panahon niya o kanyang stint bilang Secretary of Justice tong nagdaang administrasyon. So hanggang sa ngayon ay patuloy pa rin ang aming paghihintay sa labas mismo ng kanyang tanggapan sa room 502. Ito'y makikita mga kapartner sa fifth floor ng Senate Hall, so Senate Building. Kasi nga siksikan sa harap mismo ng opisina ni Senator De Lima. Nagkakatulakan, kung kita nyo naman, siksikan at yan ang ating news team. Antabay pa rin. Punong-puno mga kapartners yung harapan mismo ng pintuan ng opisina ni Senator De Lima. Dahil nga paglabas niya, inaasahan na base sa kanya mga naunang style, magbabato agad ito ng kanyang mga official pahayag at press conference ngayong hapon. Marahil ay inaasikaso na ng kampo ni Senator De Lima yung kanilang mga susunod hakbang at ang posibilidad na pwedeng o maaari kung posible ba na maharang yung pagbibigay sa kanya o paghahain sa kanya ng arrest warrant ngayong hapon. Pero sa tingin ng mga abogado, pag dyan na yung arrest warrant, walang magagawa at hindi na pwedeng pigilan yung pagsasampanga at maaresto itong si Senator De Lima. Ayan, bumukas yung pintuan ng pisina. Ayun, pumasok sa loob kuya, mga abogado.
Stop yung iba mga supporters niya.
Dinig ko may pumasok na mga taga DOJ sa loob. Wala. Ano ka uniform? Wala.
Ewan ko lang ha. Marunong pero...
Pumasok nga at akmang papasok sa loob ng tanggapan ni Senator Kiko yung si yung si LP aking chairman at president ngayon na si Senador Kiko Pangilinan. Medyo nasa likod nga lang tayo. Hindi nagbigay ng salaysay at pumasok agad si Senador Pangilinan sa loob ng opisina. Mga ating magugunita, magkasama sa partido si Senador Pangilinan at si Senador De Lima at nagpapakita lamang ng full support itong si Senador Pangilinan sa kinakarap nga ng senador. At hindi naman talaga din biro para sa isang babaeng senador na maharap sa ganitong kaseng kaso. Subalit, yun nga, ang sigaw ng taong bayan, kailangan managot ang mga nagkasala.
This is still CNN Philippines breaking news. I'm Pia Ontiveros. A warrant of arrest has been issued. The court, Branch 204, Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court, Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero, just issued moments ago. The timestamp on it is 5 o'clock p.m., February 23. It is a warrant for the arrest of Laila M. De Lima. And it says in the second paragraph, the bail for him, her, temporary liberty is hereby fixed at, and then no bail. That is on bold letters. This is exclusive to CNN Philippines. An arrest warrant is now out for Senator Laila De Lima. When you go to the bottom part of the page, you'll see that the last paragraph says, given under my hand and the seal of the court, this 23rd day of February 2017, it is signed, and there is a dry seal of the court signed by the judge, Juanita Tomas Guerrero, and you will see in a bit that dry seal of the court. Earlier, I was speaking to Senate President Coco Pimentel, and he was saying that he would like the arresting officers to bring an original copy of the warrant of arrest and not just an emailed or a faxed copy of that warrant of arrest. Now, let's speak now to one of Senator Laila De Lima's other colleagues and also a fellow Liberal Party center, former Senate President and Senator Franklin Dulon. He's on the phone. Thank you, sir, very much for joining us.
Peter, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. So I understand you're on the road, but you are on the way to the Senate.
Yes, I'm on the way to the Senate to check on what the situation is.
Okay, well, what are your thoughts, your initial thoughts, sir?
Well, certainly I am saddened by this development, but as a lawyer and officer of the court, I would advise, and I'm sure that Senator De Lima will do the same. We will respect the order of the court. I would advise Senator De Lima to respect the order of the court, but we will avail of all the legal remedies that are available to her. Bring this matter to the Court of Appeals tomorrow. Seek a restraining order because she has raised jurisdictional grounds and ask the court to provide the appellate courts to provide her with the relief that that she would need.
The matter will be brought to the Court of Appeals tomorrow, sir?
No, I'm not saying that. I am not the lawyer of...
That's just your advice. that is something that can be done.
Yes.
Okay, but in the meantime...
I don't want to substitute my judgment with that of a lawyer. Yeah. I'm not a lawyer. Uh-huh. I'm just, you know...
You're just saying that is one of the remedies available.
That is one remedy available under the rules.
Okay, but
whether
in the...
Or not,
yes.
Oh, go ahead.
But in the meantime, like you said, as an officer of the law, which is what all lawyers are, like yourself... you're saying what is important is that the order of the court is respected, and that means that Senator De Lima should voluntarily surrender, turn herself in, present herself before the court, which is anyway what she has been saying also.
Yes. There's nothing else you can do at this point, except the fact that there is a warrant of arrest, comply with it, and avail of the remedies that are outlined. Mm-hmm. In our laws and the remedies available.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, like you said a while ago, this is just your advice. It's not necessarily what her team of lawyers is considering. But if there is that possibility of seeking a restraining order from the appellate court, what happens in the meantime? Does she still have to surrender to the court? Does she still have to respond to that warrant of arrest? Or can she evade that warrant of arrest first?
She has to comply. I mean, she should not. She will not resist it, I'm sure. Mm-hmm. She will not resist the warrant of arrest. She has no choice at this point. I ask the arresting officers to respect her rights, respect her office, make sure that she is safe, not harmed. Provide her with the appropriate security, but otherwise, because Senator De Lima, I'm sure, will comply with this.
Mm-hmm. Well, what are your thoughts, Senator Drulon, about the cases that were filed against Senator De Lima? Earlier, speaking to former DSWD Secretary Dinky Suleiman, and she says she believes that Senator De Lima is innocent of all these charges. What do you think?
I don't want to comment on that. These are sub judice at this point. Mm-hmm. Already, the cases have been filed in court. Given the fact that I'm a senator, I don't want to be interpreted as interfering and using my position to interfere with the process of the court. All I'm saying is we're saddened by this development. I would advise Senator De Lima to comply with the warrant of arrest, mm-hmm. avail of the remedies under the law at this point.
Yeah. What about your advice, sir, for a place of detention?
Well, that is again up to the court, but. Mm.
treatment of the high-profile inmates in the AFP Detention Center in Campaquinaldo. Kaya bakit ay hingi ng special privilege kung sinasabi mo na hindi dapat magbigay?
Oo.
Bigyan yung mga, well, this, yung mga yeah. akusado.
Oh, this is just the idea of Senator Frank Tulon. It is not something that came from Senator De Lima. But anyway, sir, you're saying na special treatment na yon kung bibigyan siya ng house arrest. At the same time, what would the Department of Justice think in terms of a place for detention?
Well, he was seeing he himself has advanced the idea that he does not want the detained in the PNP custodial center. Mm-hmm. If he said that he does not want to be detained in the AFP custodial center, and if that would be the case, then it would be the Muntinlupa RTC who will determine the place. Actually, it should be the court who should determine the place of arrest.
Mm-hmm.
But in all other cases, less special privileges of some individuals, it is the RTC who determines the place of arrest and usually.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, almost 99% plus time, they are being ordered detained at the Muntinlupa City Jail.
Mm-hmm. Secretary Aguirre, there's quite a bit of discussion when it comes to the fact that the court, Branch 204, had scheduled a hearing tomorrow on the motion to quash that Senator De Lima's lawyers had earlier filed. At the same time, people saying that couldn't they just wait for that hearing? You know, why issue that order that finds probable cause and then issue that warrant of arrest? What do you make of something like this? Can you explain that to us, sir, in legal terms?
Well, it is not necessary that the hearing of the motion to quash would be finished, because the determination of probable cause could be done even without hearing the motion to quash. In this case, we have no doubt that the court will find probable cause against Secretary De Lima. Why? He'll ask why. Because mm-hmm. Secretary De Lima did not file any counter affidavit. In other words, he filed no defense against the charges against her.
Mm-hmm.
And for which reason, if the court will review the documents before it for the issuance of warrant of arrest, he will only find the complaints of the complainants against her.
Mm-hmm.
The court will not find any defense there because Secretary De Lima committed a blunder. Her lawyers committed a blunder by submitting a counter affidavit in including in her defense.
Mm-hmm.
That he has nothing, he has no one but herself to blame for the predicament now.
Anything else you'd like to add, Secretary Aguirre?
Well, I think the secretary of the center should welcome this as an opportunity for her to clean her name, to clear her name, because he said that she's innocent of the charges. So let us proceed with the trial and let's see if her defense is meritorious.
Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre of the Justice Department, thank you very much, sir, for joining us now.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you also.
That breaking news, of course, Branch 204, Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court had issued a warrant for the arrest of Senator Lila De Lima on drug charges. Breaking news continues in a network news special coverage at 6. I'll see you then.
Within that first year,
We have a copy of the warrant for the arrest of Senator Laila De Lima and also Rafael Marcos Ziragos and Ronnie Pisok Dayan. That warrant of arrest dated February 23, 2017, that is today. There is a time on it, 5 o'clock p.m. This is for criminal case 17-165 for violation of the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002, Section 5. Etc. Of course, this warrant says court in the second paragraph, and we quote, it is signed by Juanita Tomas Guerrero, the presiding judge of Branch 204 of the Muntinlupa RTC, and the dry seal of the branch of the RTC is there, lower right-hand corner. Like we said, this warrant of arrest has been issued by Branch 204 for Senator Laila De Lima and two other people, namely Rafael Ragos and Ronnie Dayan. Joining us now, AC Nichols, who is still at the Muntinlupa RTC. AC, what else can you tell us?
Yes, Tia. Right now, there's not really much going on here. The judge and the clerk of court, or the acting clerk of court of Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court Branch 204, left about two hours ago. There's still a couple of staff here, but they tell me that they're just basically finishing some work, not necessarily related to the case, to the drug case of Senator De Lima, but in relation to other cases. So they're just basically on overtime. Right now we're just monitoring. We're waiting if some law enforcement representatives will be coming over to get a copy of the arrest warrant, but there may be no need for that because they've already transmitted the document to whoever will be serving it, and we already got a copy of it from our sources. So right now they're telling us that there's no really need to wait here anymore, that nothing's going to happen except for tomorrow. They are expecting for representatives from both parties, from the DOJ and from the representatives of the accused to appear before the court for the scheduled hearing that's on the motion to quash filed by Senator Laila De Lima, as well as her co-accused Rafael Ragos also has a motion to quash before the court. Tia.
Yes, you've been reporting in the last few days, last few weeks. This is, of course, not the only case that is filed there at the Muntinlupa RTC. There are two more, case 17-166 and 167, filed before branches 205 and 206. Is there any news about what happened to these cases?
As far as that's right, Pia. She also has pending cases before branches 205 and 206. But as far as those two branches are concerned, last we checked before the court closed, there's no movement, there's no development in the cases. All they told us is that the motions or the pleadings filed by Senator De Lima are still on their calendar for tomorrow morning. All three branches have set these motions for tomorrow at 8:30 in the morning. Though I have to mention that the DOJ or state prosecutors have filed motions to reset the hearing for those motions from tomorrow to March 3. I believe that's on Monday, because apparently they have a legal seminar to attend tomorrow, which is mandatory for all prosecutors. So still, despite the motions to reset that they filed today, particularly this morning, the court staff tells us that the motions, particularly motion to quash and motion for judicial determination of probable cause filed by the senator on Monday, is still on their calendar. And we've seen the calendars in all three branches. The hearing is, in fact, still included in the cases to be taken up by the courts at 8:30 tomorrow morning. So there's no telling whether or not the judges will first take up the motion to reset and then eventually decide to move the hearing to a later date, to Monday, or it's also a possibility that the judge will deny or not allow the reset as requested by state prosecutors.
So, AC, whether that hearing on the motion to quash is going to be held tomorrow, February 24, or March 3, like you said, is this going to be a consolidated hearing? Is that the term for it? Because you were saying all three branches, 204, 205, and 206, mm-hmm. are going to hear this.
No, it's not going to be a consolidated hearing. These are separate courts. It's going to happen at the same time, basically. Courts will have a hearing
simultaneous
hearing, tomorrow at 8:30 in the morning.
All right. Well, thank you for clarifying that. Thank you very much, AC Nichols. If anything comes up, we'll be getting back to you very soon. Salamat po, AC Nichols. They are reporting from the Mundinlupa Regional Trial Court. What you're seeing on the left-hand side of your television screens is a live shot just outside Senator Lila De Lima's office. She is still, we are told, inside her office conferring with the staff, and we are presuming some lawyers. So we were told also a while ago that Senator Kiko Pangilinan had entered the office a while ago, also about 15 minutes ago. We were speaking to Senator Frank Rulon, who is on his way to the Senate. Both of them, both Senator Kiko and Senator Frank Rulon, Liberal Party allies of Senator Lila De Lima. Senator Rulon says that when he gets there to the Senate, he'll look at how things are going. Senator Rulon also was saying that he hopes that the court, in this case Branch 204, which had issued the warrant of arrest after finding probable cause in this case, would consider a house arrest for Senator Lila De Lima. In the meantime, let's speak first to Barry Gutierrez, a former Akbayan Party List representative. Attorney Gutierrez, thank you very much for joining us.
Yeah, that's my pleasure here.
Well, what can you tell us right now? What are your thoughts about this?
Well, you know, this was expected since last week after the Department of Justice filed the three informations against Senator De Lima. We have been expecting the warrants of arrest to issue. So the issuance this afternoon does not really come as a surprise. It's the expected next chapter in this campaign of persecution that the administration seems determined to push against Senator De Lima. And I say that based on the contents of the informations filed last week. If you go through them, they're really very, very weak. The basis is, you know, purely the testimonies of convicted drug lords who are currently incarcerated in Muntinlupa. And even the allegations themselves contained in the three informations, you know, don't seem to actually jibe with how drug trafficking, drug trading is defined under the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act of 2002. So very, very clear that this is a political vendetta being pursued against the senator, and this is just the next chapter to it.
You're saying that the government doesn't have a case against Lila de Lima?
I think that it's fairly clear that any cursory reading of the information would demonstrate to any halfway decent lawyer that the charges are really improper and are anchored on a very, very flimsy basis. I think that if there will be an honest-to-goodness review, a hearing on the motions to quash, these cases should actually be dismissed. It's probably more appropriate, given the allegations, that this be taken up by the Office of the Ombudsman and filed before the Sandigan Bayan and not the Regional Trial Court, based on the allegations, even if we take the allegations as in the information as true.
Mm. So you're saying, Attorney Gutierrez, that even if, for example, in one of the cases, Rafael Ragos testifying that he, together with one other NBI personnel, delivered money to the home of Senator Lila de Lima, that this is not enough, that this is not evidence against her?
Well, the evidence itself will have to be assessed by the court. But, you know, just to take a look at that allegation. The allegation is that money was delivered to her home. Even if we accept that that's true, you know, for the sake of argument, how does that establish a case for drug trading? Because that's what she's being charged with. She's not being charged with direct bribery. She's not being charged with organization or any other crime committed as a public officer. She's being charged as a drug trader. So in other words, a person who directly participated in drug trafficking. And, you know, if you look at the allegations, even if you assume all of them are true and all of them can be proven with adequate evidence,
they don't support.
They don't support that crime. It's a different crime altogether.
Yeah. So you're saying different crime altogether. So you're saying that if the charge was like you said, bribery, then that would be correct.
Well, if you base it on the allegations, yes. But the thing is, if it's bribery, then it shouldn't be with the RTC. It should be with the Ombudsman, filed by the Office of the Special Prosecutor and brought before the Sandigan Bayan, which I believe is actually one of the grounds that Senator De Lima's legal team raised in the motions to quash that they filed before these courts.
Okay. Well, what do you think of many comments, online, offline, etc.? People saying that now it is Senator Lila de Lima and the Liberal Party claiming a political persecution, when this is exactly what she and the other LP officials did to their opponents or their critics.
Well, you know, it's expected that they will say that. But at the end of the day, the value of that kind of assertion will have to be weighed in relation to the contents of what the charges actually are. Mm-hmm. So, for example, if people talk about the prosecution of the late Chief Justice Renat Corona as a political vendetta, then, you know, let's look at the case. Let's look at the basis. And, you know, everybody is familiar with that case. It was subject to a very, very high-profile impeachment trial before the Senate. And I think that in that particular instance, it was clear that there was a basis for pursuing cases against him. But in this particular instance, it's very, very different. The charges themselves seem to be improper. And it seems na medyo pinili talaga na gawing drug trafficking. So that's really the question. Why insist on denominating the crime as drug trafficking? Obviously, there is some kind of political motive to it.
Just one last brief question, Attorney Gutierrez.
Sure.
One of the questions earlier I had asked of several people I interviewed about 30, 45 minutes ago was related to place of detention. Senator Frank Drulon saying he hopes the court can consider house arrest. Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre saying that if that is the request that will be made by the defense, that they will object to this. Also, when I spoke to Speaker Alvarez earlier, he was saying that, he didn't mince any words. He said that she should be detained in a mental hospital.
Well, obviously, Speaker Alvarez is once again saying something completely, you know, out of bounds of what the law provides. She's being charged with a crime under our penal law. So obviously, a mental hospital is out of the question. But right now, it's really up to the court. My understanding is Senator de Lima has been prepared ever since these cases were filed. to go to a regular jail, if that is what the court will decide. Yes. I don't know whether they will actually ask for house arrest or detention in some other facility. But she's prepared to go to jail, to a regular jail, for her principles. She's going to stand by the idea that this is really a political vendetta, and she's willing to pay that particular price. That's what it takes to actually expose it for what it is.
Barry Gutierrez, former Akbayan Party List representative, thank you very much for joining us by phone.
Okay, anytime, Tia.
In the meantime, we have a statement sent in by one of our senior correspondents, Ina Andalong. The statement from presidential spokesman Ernesto Abella on the arrest of Senator Lila de Lima. It is a short two-paragraph statement. Allow me to read this. We quote, a Muntinlupa court has already issued a warrant for the arrest of Senator Lila de Lima for her alleged involvement in the illegal drug trade. Senator de Lima will now have her day in court where she will have full opportunity to prove her claim of innocence, unquote. That statement from presidential spokesman Ernesto Abella from Malacañang. We are showing you again the warrant for the arrest of Senator Lila de Lima for issued by Branch 204. Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero issued today, February 23, 2017 at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. This after the order which said that Judge Guerrero found probable cause for these charges against Senator Lila de Lima. That warrant for arrest, the order was also not just for Senator de Lima, but also for Rafael Ragos and Ronnie Dayan. Still also media waiting right outside the office of Senator Lila de Lima at the Senate. They haven't seen her yet, but we understand that she is inside that office conferring with her staff members and some lawyers. These are live pictures that you're seeing right now, just right outside the office of Senator Lila de Lima, against whom or for whom a warrant of arrest has been issued by Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero, Branch 204, Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court. We're going to take a short break. CNN Philippines will be right back. Stay with us.
Pero mamaya bigyan kita ng concrete na detalye kasi nga di ba ang nangyayari ngayon dito is yung lahat ng media entities ay nakaantabay nga sa posibleng pagdating ng magsiserve ng arrest warrant kasi ayon nga yung na-interview kanina si SOJ Aguirre, Secretary of Justice, anumang oras
din natin masabi no kung ano yung nangyayari sa loob mismo ng tanggapan ni Senator de Lima sa pagbabasa ko ng inyong mga comments dito sa ating Facebook Live. Marami talaga naghihintay din at hindi natin din masisi siguro no na matagal lumabas ang si Senator de Lima siguro ano kaya gagawin yung ilang sa mga close-in supporters niya dito sa labas is patuloy nga na paghahawi ng
patras kami
security kasi nga kanina naasahan na may kami nakatulong so kanina lang din dating ngayon mag-aay ng alas 12 kami at nagbigay siguro ng espasyo dati kanina naka ngayon yun na patakin kami kanina siguro malapit kami sa pintuan ni Sir Atwente Bigayon so kasi nga di ba inaasahan eh medyo matras kami ng konti sa style ni Sir Atwente kasi nahawi kami ng Senate Sergeant at Arms na naglalabas sa ayan napatras kami atras naman atras
some graphics one for Lila it is a
alam mo wala talagang nag-expect
na magpapalabas nga ng alas tuwaran at yung
nasasaksihan ng aktwal ng mga pangyayari ng
Muntinlupa. At siya na talaga dito sa long motion to quash at may isa pang motion, tatlong motion to quash at may dalawa pang issue na kalisado talaga yung motion iniain. At pagandahan kasi ng angulo.
Yung kampo ni Senator De Lima, naasa nila
saan kukuha ng magandang angulo sa dito.
Talunggo pa,
matras muna, pinapatras kami, medyo maingay na. Ang lahat ng mga media entities ngayong hapon.
Pagkakataon yung naglabas, nag-ref. Suwara, laman sa kanya. So, parang kak. Itong kamuni.
Yes, Father Jomel, no? Live tayo ngayon. At dito tayo ngayon mismo sa harap ng tanggapan sa room 502. May
sa tanggapan mismo.
Ni Senator Dilima sa 5th floor.
Ganyan ang tulakan dito. At
kanina lang. Alas, medyo lalayo tayo ng konti.
Pero subalit,
medyo lalayo tayo ng konti.
Kailangan daw.
Bigyan ng espasyo at pagandaan. Iba din na papasok at lalabas sa kanyang kasamahan sa Partidong Liberal. At kanina din, pumasok lang
kadadaanan.
At hindi pa lumalabas si Senador Kiko Pangilinan, yung acting president ng Liberal Party. At inaasahan niya din,
susunod na naman lagang na marami.
Marami silang
pag-uulis na nga.
At may parang yung mga day,
nagroong proseso.
Yung pagdadaanan pa.
Bigay ng pahayag o...
Pero ngayong hapon, short.
Arrest of the senator. Now, Maglalang was telling us earlier that, they are questioning the release of this warrant of arrest against the senator, given the fact that the judge, according to them, just arrived from Macau. And they're asking, how come that the court has already issued this warrant of arrest when the judge has just arrived here in the country? And if it's true that the warrant of arrest will be served today, Maglalang was telling us earlier that the senator initially is planning to go to the court to personally present herself there. But, you know, we all know that courts close at 5 in the afternoon. So we're still waiting if the camp of Senator Laila De Lima had made arrangements with the court, if, you know, if they will wait for her there or if they plan something else. Now, so far, Senators Ontiveros and Pangilinan rushed to the office of Senator Laila De Lima right after they learned that a warrant of arrest was already issued against her. Now, Pia, prior to this development, the senator attended the Jiik Ju kidnapping slay case hearing at the Senate earlier, and where she participated, and she actually gave her inputs and insights on the case. And after that, after the suspension of the hearing at around 3 in the afternoon, she went back to her office, had lunch, according to Maglalang, until the news on her the release of her warrant of arrest broke out. So currently, Pia, we're still waiting for the next move of the camp of Senator Laila De Lima, what they're going to do next, and the possible actions of her legal team. Pia.
Right, Church Cahila is there reporting from the Senate, telling us that, we've been saying since earlier, that Senator De Lima is still in her office speaking to staff, fellow senators, and lawyers, just waiting there inside. Also, earlier we spoke with Senate President Coco Pimentel. He said under Senate policy, no arrest shall be made inside Senate premises. He says law enforcers should coordinate with Senate security for any move to arrest De Lima.
Maraming palisiya namin dyan, walang aresto sa loob ng Senate premises, hindi lamang habang session o nasa plenary hall. Pero with coordination sa Senate security, pwede naman ma-enforce pa rin ang warrant of arrest kasi magko-comply naman yung subject ng arrest warrant. Hindi naman po yan tatakas na mag-evade ng service ng arrest warrant. Mm-hmm. Siya po yung magko-comply, pero coordination na po at pagdating ng law enforcers sa Senate premises, hanapin nila dapat ang chief security at ipakita yung what is their business there. Ipakita yung arrest warrant. Mm-hmm. Then the chief security should now look for the subject person to show the arrest warrant, and then mag-usap na what are the terms, how to serve the arrest warrant. Mm-hmm. Kasi iba-balance din natin yung duty naman ng mga police officers, utos kasi ng korte yan, for yeah, them to enforce the arrest warrant. Mm-hmm. And at the same time, we do not want any commotion inside the Senate premises kasi maraming mga government transactions dyan na nangyayari. Maraming tao dyan na iba-ibang business nila, iba-ibang reason nila why they are in the Senate. Mm-hmm. So mayroong mga ibang businesses naman dyan na hindi naman puro it's about Laila de Lima. So walang disruption, walang commotion, walang physical incidents po dyan sa Senado dapat.
CNN Philippines also spoke earlier to House Speaker Pantaleon Bebot Alvarez, and he says it is high time for Senator de Lima to face the charges filed against her.
Kahalimbawa, meron kang ginawang krimen no, sa ating bansa, ay talagang kinakailangan pananagutan mo. Well, siguro nung mga panahon na yon na ginawa niya yon, well, akala niya ay pwedeng matakasan. At siya na yung may kapangyarihang tao nung panahon na yon, since Justice Secretary siya. Well, bumaliktad lang siguro yung mundo talaga.
House Speaker Alvarez also suggests that de Lima be detained in a mental institution instead. Now, while the Liberal Party says de Lima's cases should be under the jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan, Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre defends his department's decision to file the cases against her and seven others before a regional trial court. Here's Anjali Mario.
Ang pag-alam ko po, these kind of offenses are not bailable because the penalty, if you are found guilty, is reclusion perpetua.
De Lima is facing three cases for violating the Dangerous Drugs Act in connection with her alleged involvement in the drug trade at the New Bilibid prison. Aguirre defends the filing of the cases with the lower court and not with the Sandigan Bayan.
These offenses belong to the exclusive original jurisdiction of the regional trial court. Wala pong jurisdiction dito ang Sandigan Bayan.
Aguirre also says the complaint filed by the NBI against Kerwin Espinosa and de Lima was dismissed. This is in connection with Espinosa's allegation de Lima received money from him to fund her senatorial campaign. The DOJ panel instead directs the NBI to further investigate Kerwin's claim. The DOJ panel also dismissed the complaint against former Undersecretary Francisco Baraan due to insufficiency of evidence. Also, the charges against inmates Peter Co, Herbert Colango, Engelberto Odorano, Jojo Baligat, and Vicente C. are dropped. They will serve as the prosecution's witnesses. Aguirre makes it clear there's nothing political in the filing of cases against de Lima.
Ito po ay hindi politika. Hindi po ito produkto ng politika. Ito po.
Put up a legal battle to block her arrest. Anjali Mario, CNN Philippines.
The Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court, Branch 204, issuing at 5 o'clock this afternoon, February 23, 2017, Thursday, a warrant for the arrest of Senator Laila de Lima on drug charges. Those are live pictures right now from the Senate. That is Senator Bam Aquino entering the office of Senator de Lima, where she is conferring with staff, colleagues at the Senate, and lawyers. We're going to take a very short break. CNN Philippines will be right back. Stay with us.
Thank you.
Live pictures from just outside the office of Senator Lila De Lima. On the door of her office, an illustration, graphics that says one for Lila. The O in one looks like a blue ribbon, very similar to the yellow ribbon that was a symbol of the Liberal Party and of former President Noynoy Aquino during the 2010 campaign. Inside or behind that door, inside Senator De Lima's office, Senator herself speaking with some of her colleagues from the Liberal Party and allies of the Liberal Party, speaking also to her staff and some lawyers, we're told. Live pictures there still. At the same time, we want to show you also live pictures from the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court, because that is where Branch 204 Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero had issued a warrant for the arrest of Senator Lila De Lima on drug charges. Criminal case 17-165 was brought before Judge Guerrero's sala. Earlier, she issued an order that said that she found probable cause for this for these charges. And at 5 o'clock this afternoon, that warrant of arrest was signed, was issued and signed by Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero. You'll see middle screen, the right hand side of your screen, it says no bail for Senator Lila De Lima. Also, AC Nichols, our justice correspondent, reporting earlier that a motion to quash hearing had been scheduled for tomorrow by each of the branches, 204, 205, and 206. We all know that cases had also been filed before those two other branches, Branch 205 under Amelia Fabros Corpus, the judge, and Branch 206 under Judge Patria Manelastas De Leon. Cecil Lardizabal joins us now from the Senate. Cecil, what can you tell us?
Hi, Pia. Right now we are on standby outside the office of Senator Lila De Lima. We were told that anytime soon they'll be giving us a statement from the senator. We haven't heard any word from her up to this time. We have been waiting for about an hour or so, but we just saw personnel from the office of the Office of the Sergeant at Arms enter the office of the senator. Also, Senator Risa Ontiveros a while ago. We also we have seen Senator Sico Pangilinan and Senator Bam Aquino went inside the room of Senator De Lima. Let us remember that those are the three members. They will directly go to the office of the Sergeant at Arms, and then the police.
Cecil? Cecil?
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead. What are you saying? They will go to the office?
Yes. That's right, and then the arresting officer will, along with the personnel of the Office of Sergeant at Arms, will directly go to the office of Senator De Lima to serve the warrant of arrest. But we have yet to hear from the arresting officers arrive at the Senate. We are all standing by and waiting for any word from the arresting officers at this time, Pia.
Cecil, can you tell us a little bit more about the graphics illustration that is taped onto the door of Senator Lila De Lima? It says one for Lila. The O in one looks like, instead of a yellow ribbon, a blue ribbon.
Yeah, we are seeing now blue ribbon posted outside the office of the senator. And, well, last week, all of the staff of the senator, they're wearing black, and also they're wearing a blue ribbon. They're telling us that it's a sign of hope. They are hoping. They are hoping that a warrant of arrest. They wouldn't want a warrant of arrest be served against the senator. But now, we've had a lot of interviews with the senator, and she's been saying that she won't resist arrest. She will go when the warrant of arrest is served to her, she will go with the arresting officers and with the OSAA personnel.
All right. Cecil, anything else you can add?
Well, at this point in time, you know, we are all standing by. We are, getting to see some people walking inside the room of the senator. We have yet to hear any word from the senator. And right now we are seeing Senator Franklin Drilon entering the office of the Senator Laila de Lima.
All right. Cecil Ardizabal there reporting from the Senate just right outside the office of Senator Laila de Lima. Senator de Lima, of course, as we know, a warrant for her arrest has been issued by the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court, Branch 204. As Cecil reported, Senator's allies of Senator de Lima inside with her. And for one, Senator Frank Rulon had just arrived about 30, 45 minutes ago. We were speaking with him, and he said he was on his way to the Senate. He was going straight to Senator de Lima's office to speak with her. Also, Bam Aquino and other senators inside there with Senator de Lima. This just an hour after the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court, Branch 204, Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero had issued or had ordered the arrest of Senator Laila de Lima and two others for criminal case 17-165 drug charges. That warrant of arrest we were showing you earlier said no bail for Senator Laila de Lima. In the meantime, we're waiting for more information. But first, 5 months ago, the House of Representatives investigated the drug trade inside the New Bilibid prison. Witnesses claimed Senator de Lima received drug money and used it to fund her 2016 senatorial campaign. Joyce Ilas takes a look back.
Several Bilibid inmates faced the House Committee on Justice investigating the proliferation of drug syndicates at the New Bilibid prison during the term of former Justice Secretary Laila de Lima. During the probe, alleged Bilibid drug lord J.B. Sebastian admitted that he gave de Lima, whom he called a protector, a total of 10 million peso worth of drug money from 2014 to 2015. Sebastian said the money was to be used for de Lima's 2016 senatorial campaign.
Sinabi ko kay Secretary de Lima, ma'am, may bigay ako sa iyong pera, paano to? Kay Junel Cubayabot. Subagot naman si Secretary de Lima na hindi ko kasama si Junel ngayon, iwan mo na lang dyan.
Another witness, convicted drug lord Herbert Colango, claimed he gave de Lima 3 million pesos monthly to allow the entry of contraband inside the Bilibid. He said he also gave her 1 million.
Because it's
and unjustly besmirched by all of these fabricated lies against about my alleged involvement in the drug trade.
In October, the House Committee on Justice ruled in its report that all of the evidence pointed to De Lima's involvement and possible accountability in the illegal drug activities. Joyce Ila, CNN Philippines.
Let's now speak to University of Santo Tomas Law Dean Nilo Divina via Viber call. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us.
Hi, Pia. Good evening.
Well, Dean, can you tell us, several people are defending Senator De Lima, saying it's a little bit unusual for Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero to have issued that order, finding probable cause and issuing a warrant of arrest just hours or days, perhaps a few days after having arrived from abroad. Can you explain to us why things are like these? Things are like this.
Well, once the information is filed in court, the judge is required to determine for himself whether or not there's probable cause to issue warrant of arrest. And usually this doesn't take long for the judge to evaluate, based on the records, if there is probable cause for the issuance of the warrant of arrest.
Well, Dean, punto.
Sorry,
ang punto po kasi ng mga dumidepensa kay Laila, kararating lang naman daw mula sa abroad si Judge Guerrero at nakapag-issue na raw kaagad ng order at ng warrant of arrest. Or is there some other way that judges are able to read whatever has been filed in their court?
Well, if the motion was to determine probable cause, then the judge should have taken time to weigh the arguments of the plaintiff. But in this case, I think what was filed is a motion to quash the information for lack of jurisdiction. So that did not stop perhaps the judge from issuing the warrant of arrest. And ordinarily, it doesn't take long for the judge to issue a warrant of arrest because that is supposed to be a summary proceeding to determine for himself whether or not there is probable cause to issue a warrant of arrest.
Summary proceeding. So it's not an
unusual for a judge to issue the warrant of arrest upon filing the information in court.
Mm-hmm. Well, another concern of those who are on the side of Senator Laila De Lima, kung, like you mentioned, the motion to quash is hearing scheduled tomorrow in branches 204, 205, and 206. Why is it that the judge would issue an order, at least Judge Guerrero of 204, when there is that pending hearing on that motion to quash? Can you explain why this is still possible?
Well, as I said, had the motion been one of to determine probable cause and then to quash the information, because you can file an omnibus motion. An omnibus motion means it raises various grounds or arguments. If what was filed is just a motion to quash and not to prevent the issuance of the warrant of arrest, then the court, I think, has the discretion to issue the warrant of arrest pending determination of that motion to quash the information.
Mm-hmm. Dean Divina, kanina po, kausap ko si Barry Gutierrez, a former Akbayan Party List representative, and he was saying na dapat daw ang chinarge na lang kay Senator Laila De Lima ay, for example, direct bribery, kung ang pag-uusapan daw ay yung pag-deliver daw ng pera ni Rafael Ragos at ng isa pang tao sa bahay niya sa para niya, sa Mutilu. Is that a relevant argument na dapat yun ang kinaso at hindi drug charges?
I think it's a relevant argument, but I think that should be raised now in the Court of Appeals. So I'm sure the lawyers of Senator De Lima are preparing the appropriate petition with the Court of Appeals because they have to contend with the fact that the judge made that ruling, the judge issued the warrant of arrest. So while it can be argued one way or the other, I think it's best for them to go up right away to the Court of Appeals and to pass the issue of the warrant of arrest. Mm-hmm.
Well, that is also what Senator Frank Dulon was telling me earlier when we spoke to him about an hour ago, that perhaps that is one of the legal remedies that she can avail of to bring this to the Court of Appeals and seek restraining order. But my question is, if they decide to do that tomorrow, does that stop or rescind? I'm not entirely sure about the warrant of arrest. Yeah. Indeed,
yes, unfortunately, PA does not stop the implementation of the warrant of arrest unless Senator De Lima can get a TRO from the Court of Appeals. Mm-hmm. So but, if the arguments are solid based on the perspective of their lawyers, I think first thing tomorrow morning, they should go up to the Court of Appeals mm-hmm. and get a TERO to restrain the implementation of the warrant of arrest.
Okay,
but I think their best shot is a CA and not with the court that issued the warrant of arrest.
Mm-hmm. But from 5 o'clock this afternoon, February 23, 2017, Thursday, until the time they can get a restraining order if they do go to the Court of Appeals, that warrant of arrest can be served at any point.
Yeah, it can be implemented because, as you know, parliamentary immunity doesn't apply if the imposable penalty is more than 6 years, as in this case.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What else is it that we need to understand, Dean Divina, about this case and all these legal procedures that are important to remember?
Well, because the warrant of arrest has been issued, once the court acquires jurisdiction over Senator De Lima, then the next step is to arraignment, or for arraignment rather. In that arraignment, she will be asked if she's guilty or not. Of course, she will say not guilty. And then after that, there will be a pre-trial, then trial, presentation of evidence by both the prosecution and defense, and then judgment. But I don't think Senator De Lima would go that far, I'm sure, at this point. She's already thinking of, preparing to file the petition with the CA to get an injunctive relief against the RTC warrant of arrest. I think the best remedy is not to fight with the RTC because it has already sort of made up its mind on the issue of the warrant of arrest. So I think the best remedy is to go up to the CA and then convince the CA that it was wrong on the part of the RTC to have issued the warrant of arrest.
Dean Anino Divina, University of Santo Tomas. Maraming salamat po, Dean, for joining us.
Thank you, Bia. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Just to recap, an order for, Senator Lila De Lima has been ordered, arrested by Branch 204 of the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court. Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero signed that warrant of arrest at 5 o'clock this afternoon, today, Thursday, February 23, 2017. It says, you can see, second paragraph, first line, the bail, no bail, in bold letters. We're going to take a short break. CNN Philippines Breaking News will be right back. We'll have more when we come back. Stay with us. Welcome back, CNN Philippines Breaking News. These are live pictures just in front of the building, the Senate of the Philippines in Pasay. A little bit of the movement there now that the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court, Branch 204, Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero had issued a warrant for the arrest of Senator Lila De Lima. Senator Lila De Lima still inside her office speaking to several of her colleagues and her staff and some of the lawyers. She's inside her office. There is as yet no clear information as to whether there are law enforcement officials inside Senate premises that will be serving that warrant of arrest on Senator De Lima. These are live pictures just right outside the office of Senator De Lima. You can see, as we had been pointing out earlier, a sign on the door that was taped onto the door. It says one for Lila. The O in the one is a blue ribbon, very similar to the yellow ribbon that the Liberal Party and former President Noynoy Aquino used during the 2010 campaign, the presidential campaign. And speaking of the Liberal Party, there is the Liberal Party senators had issued a statement on the arrest of, or I'm sorry, on the pending arrest of Senator Lila De Lima. And let me read it for you. This is dated of today, of course, February 23. And we quote, the Liberal Party reiterates that it condemns the political persecution of brave administration critic Senator Lila De Lima. We repeat, the statement goes on, the Sandigan Bayan, not regional trial court, has jurisdiction over the case as the alleged wrongdoings were supposedly committed when she was Justice Secretary. Ang balita namin, the statement goes on, kararating lang ng Macau nitong judge, ang alam namin makapal ang motion to quash na final sa kanyang korte, basahin naman niya ang motion. The haste is deplorable. And further, the statement says, we fear for Senator Lila's life and security given what happened to Albuera Mayor Espinosa. They are referring to Rolando Espinosa of Albuera Leyte, who was killed inside his jail cell, and Korean businessman Jiik Ju were both killed, like we said, inside police-controlled facilities. This arrest, the statement goes on, is purely political vendetta and has no place in the justice system that upholds the rule of law. The last paragraph reads, we maintain that if this warrant of arrest is served, it would be a clear violation of legal proceedings and is therefore a violation of her constitutional right to due process. Just a while ago, I was speaking to Dean Nilo Divina, explaining that this is a matter of course, an arrest warrant will be issued. So far, he says nothing irregular in what the court, what Branch 204 had done. And while the Liberal Party says De Lima's cases should be under the jurisdiction of the Sandigan Bayan, Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre defends his decision to file the cases against De Lima and seven others before a regional trial court. Here's Angelo Limario.
Ang pag-alam ko po, these kind of offenses are not bailable because the penalty, if you are found guilty, is reclusion perpetua.
De Lima is facing three cases for violating the Dangerous Drugs Act in connection with her alleged involvement in the drug trade at the New Bilibid prison. Aguirre defends the filing of the cases with the lower court and not with the Sandigan Bayan.
These offenses belong to the exclusive original jurisdiction of the regional trial court. Wala pong jurisdiction dito ang Sandigan Bayan.
Aguirre also says the complaint filed by the NBI against Kerwin Espinosa and De Lima was dismissed. This is in connection with Espinosa's allegation De Lima received money from him to fund her senatorial campaign. The DOJ panel instead directs the NBI to further investigate Kerwin's claim. The DOJ panel also dismissed the complaint against former Undersecretary Francisco Baraan due to insufficiency of evidence. Also, the charges against inmates Peter Co, Herbert Colango, Engelberto Odorano, Jojo Baligat, and Vicente C. are dropped. They will serve as the prosecution's witnesses. Aguirre makes it clear there's nothing political in the filing of cases against De Lima.
Ito po ay hindi politika. Hindi po ito produkto ng politika. Ito po ay produkto ng trading sa droga.
Ask if he's confident De Lima will be convicted.
Hindi po naman to file ng National Prosecution Service kung hindi mayroong probability na ito'y na siya ay mahatulan.
De Lima, for her part, is expected to put up a legal battle to block her arrest. Anjoli Mario, CNN Philippines.
CNN Philippines breaking news continues. The Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court had ordered Branch 204. Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero had ordered the arrest of Senator Lila De Lima for criminal case 17-165. That warrant for her arrest was signed at 5 o'clock this afternoon, today, Thursday, February 23rd. Right now, as our reporters in the Senate, Cecily Lardizabal and George Quiles reporting, no sighting yet of any law enforcement officer who's bringing that warrant for her arrest. Several of her colleagues had been inside with her in her office, speaking to her together with her staff and lawyers. We're also told by our Cecily Lardizabal that Senator De Lima is about to hold a press conference in one of the rooms of the Senate building right now. And we're told that that's going to be happening in a few moments. About 2 hours after that warrant for her arrest was issued. We're waiting for that. Also, we're told that President Rodrigo Duterte is at an event in SMX in Davao City. He is, well, as he usually does, he is expected perhaps to say a few words. We're not sure if he will speak about this arrest order that Sandra de Lima, that had been issued for Sandra de Lima. These are live pictures courtesy of RTVM from Davao in SMX Davao. That's where President Duterte is. We're going to be seeing him in a little bit. We're also waiting for that press conference of Senator Laila de Lima. Just to recap just a little bit, Branch 204, one of three branches before which cases, drug cases, were filed against Senator Laila de Lima. The judge, Juanita Tomas Guerrero, had issued an order finding probable cause and then issued at 5 o'clock this afternoon a warrant for the arrest of Senator de Lima. That warrant for arrest said no bail. Earlier, we were speaking to Senator Coco Pimentel, Senate President, and all he said was what was important was that there was coordination, or that there is going to be coordination and respect from law enforcement officers. He doesn't want any scene to happen at the Senate. At the same time, he said, as far as he knows, Senator Laila de Lima had said many times over that she would be cooperating with authorities. We also spoke with Senator Franklin Drulon, one of the Liberal Party senators and an ally of Senator de Lima. And he said, although he was saddened by this development, that he, as a lawyer and as an officer of the court, that Senator de Lima should, and he expected her, as she said she would, to respect the order of the court. But he also said that she can bring, one of the legal remedies would be for her to bring this before the Court of Appeals and perhaps seek a restraining order. This is the same thing that University of Santo Tomas Law Dean Nilo Davina told us just 5 minutes ago, that this is one of the legal remedies that Senator de Lima can take to go to the Court of Appeals, the appellate court, and to try and get a restraining order. But Nilo Davina explaining there that even if that is brought to the Court of Appeals, that does not mean that the warrant for Senator de Lima's arrest cannot be served on her. We're going to take a very short break. CNN Philippines Breaking News will be right back. Stay with us. Welcome back, CNN Philippines Breaking News. Live pictures from inside the Senate. This is just right outside the office of Senator Laila de Lima. Media people there waiting for her to come out. She said she sent out word that she is going to be holding a press conference anytime. In the meantime, while we wait for that press conference to happen, just 2 hours after the Regional Trial Court of Muntinlupa, Branch 204, had issued a warrant for her arrest, we're going to be speaking to Senator Antonio Trillanes, who is not at the Senate right now, but we're told, he told us just a while ago that he did speak to Senator Laila de Lima by phone. Senator Trillanes, can you tell us what is it that Senator de Lima and you spoke about?
Well, I talked to her a few hours ago, and she told me that if I could help in coordinating with the Philippine National Police so that her safety and security would be guaranteed. And that's why after that I called General Ubusan, and he gave me his word that he would guarantee the safety and security of Senator de Lima. So I told Senator De Lima about our conversation, and I trust General Ubusan because I also coordinated with him when we turned over Edgar Matubato last year. So I trust General Ubusan's word.
You're referring to General Ubusan of the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, CIDG?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay, so are you telling us that it is the CIDG that will be bringing that warrant of arrest, that will be serving that warrant of arrest?
Well, that time, General Ubusan has yet to receive the warrant officially. So he said other law enforcement agencies theoretically could serve that warrant. Mm-hmm. But should he be the one to designated to arrest Senator De Lima, she guarantees not only her safety and security, but also that she would be treated well.
Okay.
And yes.
Well, Senator, since the court had issued that order finding probable cause, and then at 5 o'clock this afternoon, issuing that warrant for Senator De Lima's arrest, have you been able to speak to General Ubusan?
I believe we talked. Past five already, but essentially that's the picture, and he said for as long as he has yet to serve the warrant officially, the senator can go home and make the necessary farewells to her family and prepare her things. So there's no rush to effect the arrest this evening, because ordinarily for those being served warrants, normally they do it during office hours.
All right. So you're saying that Director Roel Ubusan of the CIDG was saying that if it were he or his men who would serve that warrant for the Senator De Lima's arrest, that he would allow her to go home, meaning spend the night at home first and say proper goodbyes, pack her things, etc., and be presented to the Muntinlupa RTC tomorrow.
Yes, because that's the normal procedure. They do it during office hours. Mm-hmm. And since Senator De Lima publicly said that she will face this thing head on, then and there's also no flight risk. So I believe it's a judgment call of General Ubusan.
All right. Is there anything else you can share with us, Senator Trillanes?
Well, first of all, I would like to denounce this acts of persecution by the Duterte administration that is primarily targeting the dissenting voices against his administration. But we will not be cowed. We will continue to be voices of what is right and what is just. So in the proper time, we will make the necessary response.
Senator Antonio Trillanes, thank you very much, sir, for joining us by telephone.
Salamat, ma'am.
Senator Trillanes there saying that he spoke earlier to CIDG Chief Director Roel Ubusan, who said, and we quote, according to Senator Trillanes, that if it were he or the CIDG personnel who would be serving that warrant for the arrest of Senator De Lima, that he would allow her to go home tonight, prepare her things, and say the proper goodbyes before she is presented to the Muntinlupa RTC tomorrow. Meantime, our George Cahiles joins us now from the Senate grounds. George, what do you have for us right now?
Well, Pia, we spoke with Senate Sergeant at Arms Jose Balahadia earlier, and he told us that arresting units have yet to coordinate with them in relation to the possible arrest of Senator Laila De Lima. In fact, he said that they aren't really sure if there's already a warrant of arrest because they have yet to receive a copy of this arrest warrant as of the moment. Balahadia says he is giving a briefing to Senate Security as of the moment, telling them what to do in any scenario that may happen in case that some arresting units will arrive here at the Senate grounds and try to arrest Senator Laila De Lima. And he says the office of Senator Laila De Lima has yet to ask for security arrangements as of yet. But what we know so far is that the senator is still at the Senate building in her office. And in a little while, she will give a press briefing. But the Senate president told Balahadia that
to ensure that those arresting units will somehow coordinate with them properly as a co-equal branch of the government as a form of respect. Pia.
All right, George Quiles, they're reporting from the Senate. This is going to be interesting because, like George was saying and Cecil was saying, that Senator De Lima is scheduled to give a press briefing anytime now. But at the same time in Davao City, like you were saying, President Duterte addressing an international conference of the Knights of Rizal. Let's listen in first. Major,
I did not know then how deeply ingrained and enormous those problems were. Nonetheless, and early on, I felt that there must be a meaningful change or reform. With those occupying the highest positions in government. We know what we need or ought to do, but we do not do them because our concept of government is parochial and we cannot rise above our family, ethnic, and clan loyalties. As we push through ourselves to a better Philippines, I recall Dr. Cerizal's writing, thus, I have also written that change or reforms, if they are to bear fruit, must come from the above. For change or reforms that come below are upheavals, both violent and transitory. Perhaps it would be good for us to revisit the wisdom contained in the words of Dr. Jose Rizal, which reverberate from centuries past. To start with, after Rizal published the Nolimit Tangiri, he created a lot of enemies. And Father Sanchez of the Society of Jesus, who feared for his life and safety and security, warned him of terrible consequences. He asked Dr. Jose Rizal, "You do not fear the consequences of your boldness?" Rizal answered, "Father, you are a missionary. When you are on a mission, do your duty without fear of consequences. Are you not afraid to?" Father Sanchez retorted, "That is completely a different thing." Rizal said, "Not at all, Father. Your mission is to baptize pagans. Mine is to dignify men." In his letter to Resurrection Hidalgo, he said, "I have laughed at my misfortunes because nobody wanted to weep with me." These are but two of the countless messages of the wisdom that Dr. Jose Rizal either said or wrote. But these two meaningful outstand because of their simplicity and richness in the meaning and implication. To say that Dr. Jose Rizal was ahead of his time is no empty statement. For instance, my administration has proposed to shift from our governmental structure to a federal system. But it is really nothing new, for in this, the Filipinas, dentro de 100 años, the Philippine century since published at La Solidaridad circa 1989, and 1890. Dr. Jose Rizal saw the merits and the advantages of a federal system of government. No wonder he predicted that the Philippines would probably adopt a federal republic once liberated. For now, we do not need to discuss what these advantages are. That will follow later. Frankly, I hope to see the Knights of Rizal in the forefront of the campaign to shift to the federal type of government. All of us know how Dr. Jose Rizal died, but we do not know how he lived. Men become heroes not so much because they have died, but more so of how they live. Indeed, Dr. Jose Rizal's life was a heroic struggle to dignify the Filipino. As aptly said by Leon Maria Guerrero, It was when he was commissioned to write a brief of Dr. Jose Rizal's life that he discovered that the way Dr. Jose Rizal died was not so important as the way he lived. And since his life was essentially apostleship, the way he lived was not so much important as what he thought and wrote. One's thoughts revealed in the words, government one's life. That is how things are. Dr. Jose Rizal is as relevant to us now as he was in this nation during his lifetime. His words echo and re-echo through the years, but sad to say, it seems that we have not profited enough from their wisdom. We need to re-examine our conscience along the lines of Dr. Jose Rizal. Rizal's thoughts, aspirations, and vision. And then decide whether we strengthen the bond that unites us as a people and nation, or tear this country apart. Finally, let us not delude ourselves into believing that Dr. Jose Rizal was a faultless being, because he was not. He was mortal like us. Summing up the person that Dr. Jose Rizal was, Leon Maria Guerrero, in 1961 award-winning biography of Dr. Jose Rizal entitled The First Filipino. Rizal was not perfect, and he was not always right. But I trust that those who read the story of his life will perceive that his humanity is precisely the secret of his greatness. You can be a Rizal, I can be a Rizal, in our own modest ways and within the limits of our competence and capacities, we can all be Rizals. Thank you and good evening to all.
Thank you, Mr. President. May we request the President for a photo opportunity with Sir Renato Espuno Sr. and Sir Lamberto Nanquil in 12 batches. May I call on batch one, members.
A brief speech by President Duterte on the Knights of Rizal, that event he's attending at the SMX Davao. On your, the upper right hands of your upper left hand of your screens, you can see just outside the office of Senator Laila de Lima. By the way, President Duterte made no mention of her today. Upper left hand of your screens, you can see a little bit of a commotion just outside her office. Senator Laila de Lima there, exiting her office, proceeding to the Sumulong room where she's going to be holding a press conference. A little bit of a physical event going on there as Senate security escorting Senator De Lima, presumably to her press conference, where she's going to be holding a press conference. Just at 5 o'clock this afternoon, the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court Branch 204 had issued a warrant for her arrest for criminal case 17-165. These are drug charges that were filed against her by the Department of Justice. Well, right now what you're seeing live pictures still, Senator De Lima emerging from her office, but going down the stairwell. We were told earlier that she was supposed to have a press conference where, and we're showing you Sumulong Room, where the press conference is supposed to be held, and that is where we're expecting that she will be entering anytime soon. Of course, as we know, like I said, like we were saying earlier, Branch 204 had issued a warrant for her arrest, no bail, according to the order that Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero had signed. That order was signed at 5 o'clock this afternoon, February 23rd, Thursday, February 23rd, 2017.
Hey, We're expecting Senator De Lima any moment now to enter this room for that press conference where she said she's going to be giving anytime soon, and that is her entering the press conference room in the Senate. Well, while we're waiting for her to begin that press conference, like we said, a warrant for her arrest had been issued just a while ago. We spoke to Senator Antonio Trillanes, and he was saying that at around 5 o'clock this afternoon, Senator Trillanes had spoken to Director Roel Obusan, who heads the PNP-CIDG, or the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, and that Director Obusan had assured Senator Trillanes that if it were the CIDG that would serve that warrant for Senator De Lima's arrest, that they would allow her to go home first tonight to prepare her things and to say proper goodbyes, and that they could always bring her, present her to the court tomorrow. It's quite a number of Senate security. I'm presuming that is what they are, if I'm seeing them correctly. These are the men in black jackets, or about five, six, or seven of them surrounding Senator De Lima. The senator herself is seated right behind that podium that you can see on the stage. To Senator De Lima's right and to our left, the left of the podium, as we can see it, is Senator Bam Aquino, who was with her earlier in her office. Still a little bit of commotion, quite a bit of noise there as the media waits for that press conference to begin. It is not yet clear what exactly Senator De Lima is going to be saying, but what exactly she's going to announce as to when she will be presenting herself before the Muntinlupa RTC. You can see Senator Kiko Pangilinan and Frank Trulon, her fellow Liberal Party senators, joining her for that press conference.
Tahimik muna po tayo. Magsasalita lang po ako pag tahimik na lahat. Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Katulad po ng napabalita, may linabas na order of arrest and corresponding warrant of arrest ang RTC Muntinlupa. Pero sa ngayon po, wala pa ho sa akin siniserve. Bagamat questionable yung pagkaka-issue ng warrant of arrest or ng order of arrest, questionable ho dahil dapat po bukas ay didinggin muna yung inihain ng aming mga abogado na motions to quash doon sa tatlong kaso. Sa katunayan, yung prosecution nga po, specifically DOJ, ay nagpa-postpone pa nga, nagpa-reset po nung hearing bukas for March 3. Kaya po, nagulat po kami lahat na biglang in-issue yung order of arrest and warrant of arrest. Katulad po ng nasabi ko na dati, wala po akong balak takasan yung mga kaso ko. Wala po akong balak magtago dahil haharapin ko po ang mga kaso na yan. Since ngayon po, at this very moment, 7:20. Wala pa naman po nagsiserve ng warrant of arrest sa akin. ninanais ko muna po na umuwi muna para makapiling ko na muna po. Ang aking pamilya. At para kunin ko na po yung mga dadaling kong gamit sa kulungan. So uuwi po ako ngayong gabi at babalik po ako dito bukas na umaga. At dito ko po sa Senado hihintayin ang arresting team. Hihintayin ko po sila. Kusa po ako nasusuko sa kanila. Pero sa ngayon po, gusto ko na muna po makapiling ang aking pamilya sa bahay. Babalik po ako bukas na umaga. Ipapasalamat po ako sa mga kasamahan ko sa Liberal Party. Senator Frank Drilon, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, Senator Bam Aquino, at Senator Risa Ontiveros, nandito po siya kanina, sa kanilang suporta. Sa inyo pong lahat, humihingi lang po ako ng inyong dasal na sana maging safe and secure po ako saan man nila ako dadalhin, saan man nila ako ikukulong. Alam nyo naman po na yung mga so-called charges na final sa akin ay non-bailable. Bahala na po ang aking mga abogado kung ano po ang legal remedy na gagawin nila dyan sa questionable nga pong pagkaka-issue ng order of arrest and warrant of arrest ngayon. Tuloy po ang laban ni Laila De Lima. Maraming salamat po.
Senator Laila De Lima there saying that she acknowledges that there is that order of arrest that the Regional Trial Court Branch 204, the Muntinlupa RTC had issued, and it issued an order of arrest and a corresponding order of arrest. She said that as of now, nothing had yet been served to or on her. And she said that even if it was questionable, she said that she has been questioning this for the longest time, that she had no plans, has no plans to evade the serving of the warrant of the arrest, and no plans to go into hiding. And she said that since no one has come here, gone to the Senate to serve that warrant for her arrest on her, that she said that she wants to go home first so that she can be with her family to pack her things, which she will be bringing to her place of detention. And she said that she wants to return to the Senate tomorrow morning, where she will wait for the arresting team. And she also said that, and she said she also asked for prayers for her safety and security. After that very brief, the very brief statement from her, she left the Sumulong room right away and is expected to be leaving the Senate premises in a few moments or in a few minutes. Our correspondents are standing by, George Cahiles and Cecil Lardizabal there at the Senate. AC Nichols is at the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court. We have several other correspondents all over the place waiting for any developments on this issuance of an arrest warrant for Senator Laila De Lima. Just a while ago, Senator Trillanes was explaining that at 5 o'clock this afternoon, he had spoken to Director Ruel Obusan of the PNP CIDG, who said that it was possible for sent de Lima to go home first tonight and to prepare her things, exactly as Senator de Lima mentioned during her press conference. Now let's speak first to Cecil Ardizabal, who was at that press conference, very brief press conference of Senator Lila de Lima. Cecil, what else can you tell us?
Hi, Pia. We've seen the press conference of Senator Lila de Lima. She appeared very emotional. And then she was saying that an arrest warrant has yet to be served to her. She's clearing that, although we know that it has been already issued by the RTC Muntinlupa. What she's appealing is for her security for the authorities, and that she wants to go home first, and that she will be back here at the Senate tomorrow and will wait for the arrest warrant. During her press conference, she was accompanied by LP member senators, Senator Frank Rilon, Bam Aquino, and Kiko Pangilinan. All of her staff was also with her during her press conference. It was very short, and she made her message clear that she's not going to resist arrest, but that she just wants to go home to see her family first, and then to talk to them for the last time before she voluntarily, surrenders herself to the authorities when an arrest warrant is served tomorrow, if and when that happens, Pia.
Well, Cecil, we're seeing live pictures from just outside the Senate, three, four vehicles leaving the Senate premises. Sorry, five. We're presuming that that is Senator Lila de Lima. She said she wanted to go home first to be with her family and pack her things. Can you tell us a little bit more?
Well, yeah, I'm here at the second floor. I haven't seen that convoy yet, Pia, but, that was the wish of the senator, that she wants to go home first and see her family and, talk to her children and her grandchildren. Those are the things she said that she is going to miss, the people that she loves, her home, if and when an arrest warrant is served. And she made it clear, her message, that she will get back here at the Senate tomorrow and wait for the warrant of arrest to be served to her. Pia.
All right, Cecil Ardizabal there at the second floor, like she said, of the Senate, having just covered the very brief press conference of Senator Lila de Lima. Also, just a few seconds ago, we were showing you a live shot of that convoy. We are presuming that that is Senator Lila de Lima on her way home. Like she said, she wanted to go home first to speak to her children. She has two children and her grandchildren, and she wanted to pack her things for detention. And she said that she would be back at the Senate tomorrow morning, where she would wait for the arresting officers who would be bringing that arrest warrant for her. That arrest warrant that was issued just at 5 o'clock this afternoon, that's about 2.5 hours ago, by the Branch 204 of the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court. On the left-hand side of your screens, you can still see a live shot of the convoy. Like I said, we presume that that is the convoy of Senator Lila de Lima. Like she said, she wanted to go home first tonight, but that she will not evade arrest and she will not go into hiding. This is something that she's been saying for the last few weeks, that she is willing to face this. All right, live pictures, like we said, on the left-hand side, live pictures, that convoy on its way home, or on its way to the home of Senator Lila de Lima. We're going to speak to George Cahiles, who is with that convoy. George?
Yes, Pia, we're currently tailing the convoy of Senator Lila de Lima. We're here in the area of Macapagal. Oh, well, this is already Buendia, in front of World Trade Center. But, mentioned by the senator, she's going home tonight to be with her family. And tomorrow she will be back at the Senate to wait for the arresting officers to serve the warrant of arrest against her. So currently several vehicles are a part of this convoy. And, of course, media men, including us, are now tailing the convoy going to her house, Parañaque. So in a little while, Pia, we'll give you further updates. And this is a very secured convoy. We've seen several security personnel manning the various vehicles that are part of the convoy. And we will give you in a bit more updates on our whereabouts and until we reach the house of Senator Laila de Lima in Parañaque. Pia.
And George, no sightings whatsoever of any elements of the Philippine National Police or of this PNP CIDG in the Senate premises?
Oh, well, so far, Pia, there is no sighting of CIDG members here. And as far as our sources in Kamkrame told us that they're still there in the area and on standby, but there's no apparent order from the CID chief if they will be having an activity tonight. So, so far, Pia, the police officers that we've seen are those manning the Senate grounds. Those are just the policemen that we've seen so far. But so as of now, we haven't seen any CIDG officers in the area, Pia.
So your sources in Crame saying no movement from there, no one, no teams are going out of Crame to serve that warrant of arrest so far for today.
Yes, Pia, that's correct. As of now, there is no order to have their activity or movement tonight, particularly on arresting the senator. And they're still there in Kamkrame. The CIDG NCR officials are still there in Kamkrame. Yeah.
George, personnel securing Senator Laila de Lima, these are, we presume, Senate security, correct?
Yes, Pia. We are assuming that they are Senate security. They're wearing the this gray top, polo barong, jacket that is normally the uniform of Senate security personnel. So they are aboard several vehicles. And they're still also trailing the convoy of Senator Laila de Lima. Yeah.
Were you able to see, watch as Senator de Lima boarded her vehicle, or you were medyo malayo yung kinalalagyan niyo kanina, George?
Well, actually, the vehicles came from parking space, which is at the basement of the Senate building. So we weren't able to see if the senator was, in which vehicle the senator boarded. But what we know is that this is the convoy of the senator, but we did not have the chance to see her aboard the vehicle. Yeah.
All right. Well, George Cahila, we're going to be checking in with you in just a bit. I suppose by the time you get to the residence of Senator Laila de Lima. For those of you just joining us now, Senator Laila de Lima, having just left the Senate after a very brief press conference. During that press conference, she was saying that she wanted to go home first tonight, and that since no law enforcement official had served that warrant for her arrest on her, that she would return home first to be able to pack her things for detention and to speak first and spend time with her two children and her grandchildren. And she said that by tomorrow morning she would be back at the Senate, where she would wait for any arresting officer who would bring that warrant for her arrest. She also said during that press conference that she did not or does not have a copy of that warrant for her arrest. We're going to show you again that speech, a very brief statement made by Senator Laila de Lima during that press conference moments ago, just before she left the Senate.
Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Katulad po ng napabalita, may linabas na order of arrest and corresponding warrant of arrest ang RTC Muntinlupa. Pero sa ngayon po, wala pa ho sa akin siniserve. Bagamat questionable yung pagkaka-issue ng warrant of arrest or ng order of arrest, questionable ho dahil dapat po bukas ay didinggin muna yung inihain ng aming mga abogado na motions to quash doon sa tatlong kaso. Sa katunayan, yung prosecution nga po, specifically DOJ, ay nagpa-postpone pa nga, nagpa-reset po nung hearing bukas for March 3. Kaya po, nagulat po kami lahat na biglang in-issue yung order of arrest and warrant of arrest. Katulad po ng nasabi ko na dati, wala po akong balak takasan yung mga kaso ko. Wala po akong balak magtago dahil haharapin ko po ang mga kaso na yan. Since ngayon po, at this very moment, 7:20, wala pa naman po nagsiserve ng warrant of arrest sa akin, ninanais ko muna po na umuwi muna para makapiling ko na muna po. Ang aking pamilya. At para kunin ko na po yung mga dadalhin kong gamit sa kulungan. So uuwi po ako ngayong gabi at babalik po ako dito bukas na umaga. At dito ko po sa Senado hihintayin ang arresting team. Ihintayin ko po sila. Kusa po ako. Nasusuko sa kanila. Pero sa ngayon po, gusto ko na muna po makapiling ang aking pamilya sa bahay. Babalik po ako bukas na umaga. Ipapasalamat po ako sa mga kasamahan ko sa Liberal Party. Senator Frank Drilon, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, Senator Bam Aquino, at Senator Risa Ontiveros, nandito po siya kanina, sa kanilang suporta. Sa inyo pong lahat, tumihingi lang po ako ng inyong dasal na sana maging safe and secure po ako saan man nila ako dadalhin, saan man nila ako ikukulong. Alam nyo naman po na yung mga so-called charges na final sa akin ay non-bailable. Bahala na po ang aking mga abogado kung ano po ang legal remedy na gagawin nila dyan sa questionable nga pong pagkaka-issue ng order of arrest and warrant of arrest ngayon. Tuloy po ang laban ni Laila De Lima. Maraming salamat po.
Senator Laila De Lima giving that very brief statement just moments ago before she left the building. George Quiles is tailing her convoy. It is on its way to her home south in the southern part of Metro Manila. George Quiles there telling us a bit earlier that Senate security are escorting Senator Laila De Lima, who said, just as you heard a while ago, that she wanted to go home first and be with her children and grandchildren and to prepare her things for detention. She also said that she wanted to return to the Senate tomorrow morning where she would be waiting for the arresting officers. At 5 o'clock this afternoon, the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court Branch 204, through Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero, issuing that warrant of arrest that you can see it right now on your screens. That was issued at 5 o'clock this afternoon. The first line, very clearly, you can see that you're hereby commanded to arrest Laila M. De Lima. The second paragraph, first line of the second paragraph, says the bail for this person. I'm sorry, I can't see the exact words. No bail, and that is in bold letters. That warrant of arrest issued for Senator Laila De Lima at 5 o'clock this afternoon by Judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero of the Branch 204 Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court.
Doon sa tatlong kaso. Sa katunayan,
Now, one of Senator De Lima's supporters and former DSWD Secretary Dinky Soliman comments on the order to have De Lima arrested. Soliman describes it as a travesty of justice.
I think this is a travesty of justice. And secondly, I think this is to make people forget that there is even a more explosive news that we should be paying attention to. That there is this man who has said, Las Cañas, that the president had actually asked him to kill people. We should not forget that. At the same time, I say Senator Laila De Lima is not guilty. The evidence they have on her is given by people who were the ones perpetrating the drug trade when they were outside of jail and when they were inside of jail. And it was Senator De Lima who brought that all out into public.
Meanwhile, Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre saying it is all up to the regional trial court to decide the place of arrest and where De Lima should be detained. De Lima had said before that she does not want to be detained at the PNP custodial center.
She does not want to be detained in the PNP custodial center. If he said that she does not want to be detained in the AFP custodial center. And if that would be the case, then it would be the Muntinlupa RTC who will determine the place. Actually, it should be the court who should determine the place of arrest. But in other cases, in all other cases, less special privileges of some individuals, it is the RTC who determines the place of arrest and usually. In fact, almost 99% plus time, they are being ordered detained at the Muntinlupa City Jail.
Meantime, a statement, an official statement of the national president of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines, IBP, regarding Senator De Lima's call urging the IBP to stand up as defenders of truth and justice. That statement entitled, "We Stand for the Rule of Law." Please be patient. I'm just going to read a few lines from it. We quote, "The IBP will always faithfully and vigilantly stand for the rule of law, respect for human rights, and upholding the Constitution of the Philippines. Our resolve on this matter has never slackened, and in pursuit thereof, the IBP has relentlessly pursued the interests of the downtrodden, from our Lumad brothers and sisters to the oppressed farmers of Mindanao, as well as other victims of human rights abuses. And the IBP has consistently spoken against extrajudicial killings. Being an inherently apolitical organization," the statement goes on, "the IBP is also duty-bound to desist from participating in any partisan politics and, like Caesar's wife, to avoid even the perception of being tainted with any political color. To be clear, the IBP shall stand ready, willing, and able to assist and defend anyone who is oppressed, abused, or any other victim of injustice. But the national leadership of the IBP shall not allow the institution's name to be sullied by allowing itself to be dragged into the murky world of political mudslinging." That statement dated today, 23 February 2017, and signed by Attorney Rosario Setias Reyes, National President of the IBP. Meantime, George Kahila is still part of that convoy. Senator Laila De Lima on her way home, like she said, she wanted to spend her last night of freedom at home with her children and preparing her things for her detention. She said she would be returning to the Senate tomorrow morning, where she would wait for arresting officers who would bring that warrant for her arrest, issued at 5 o'clock this afternoon, Thursday, February 23rd, by Branch 204 of the Regional Trial Court of Muntinlupa. Now, meantime, Senator Franklin Drilon says he is saddened by the new developments on De Lima's case, but that he respects the rule of the court or the rule of law. He hopes, however, that the court may allow De Lima to be put on house arrest instead.
I hope that the court can consider allowing her a house arrest. She is not a flight risk. The important thing is that she is under the custody of the court. Wherever the court would want to detain her, it's a matter for the court to decide.
5 months ago, the House of Representatives investigated the drug trade inside the New Bilibid prison. Witnesses claim Senator De Lima received drug money and used it to fund her 2016 senatorial campaign. Joyce Ilas takes a look back.
Several Bilibid inmates faced the House Committee on Justice investigating the proliferation of drug syndicates at the New Bilibid prison during the term of former Justice Secretary Laila De Lima. During the probe, alleged Bilibid drug lord J.B. Sebastian admitted that he gave De Lima, whom he called a protector, a total of 10 million peso worth of drug money from 2014 to 2015. Sebastian said the money was to be used for De Lima's 2016 senatorial campaign.
Sinabi ko kay Secretary De Lima, ma'am, may bigay ako sa iyong pera, paano to? Kay Junel Cobayabot. Subagot naman si Secretary De Lima na hindi ko kasama si Junel ngayon, iwan mo na lang dyan.
Another witness, convicted drug lord Herbert Colango, claimed he gave De Lima 3 million pesos monthly to allow the entry of contraband inside the Bilibid. He said he also gave her 1 million pesos every time he held a concert inside the Bilibid.
Ang tatawag sa amin yan ay PR payola po. Para lahat ng gusto namin mga kontrabando ay papasok. Golf cart, motor de Corinthe.
Other inmates also claimed personally giving De Lima millions worth of drug money.
Inabot ko na kay Secretary De Lima ang kahon na may lamang 1.5 million. At sinabi ko, ma'am, ito na po. Kinuha ito ni Secretary at inabot sa lalaking sumalubong sa akin.
I said, good morning ma'am. He said, she said, hi Rafi. As long as we entered and Ronnie handed the black bag. And she accepted it.
Other convicts meanwhile claimed that Sebastian and Colango ordered them to sell drugs inside and outside the Bilibid to fund De Lima's 2016 senatorial campaign.
Alam ko na direktang para kay Secretary Laila De Lima mismo ang 1,500,000 piso at ito'y taasang inamin ni Herbert Colango sa akin.
De Lima's former driver turned lover Ronnie Dayan said he received the money from alleged drug lord Kerwin Espinosa for De Lima. Dayan, however, said he did not know that Espinosa was a drug lord or how much money Espinosa was giving De Lima.
Inaabot po ang mga ito kay ma'am pagdating sa bahay. Sa mismong kwarto, automatic na po yan.
In the end, some congressmen seemed to be convinced that De Lima may have been involved in the illegal drug trade.
Here is a woman pretending to be clean, pretending to be a crime buster, a graft buster, a self-proclaimed righteous individual. Kailangan nating ipakita sa taong bayan kung anong klaseng tao ito.
But others question the motives and the inconsistencies in the statements of convicts turned witnesses.
Para sa akin kasi gusto mo lang sabihin yung pwede na pwede mong sabihin pero yung pwede mong itago, itatago mo.
For De Lima, the statements of convicts were nothing but lies meant to destroy her.
My reputation has been untarnished until now when it's being unfairly and unjustly besmirched by all of these fabricated lies against about my alleged involvement in the drug trade.
In October, the House Committee on Justice ruled in its report that all of the evidence pointed to De Lima's involvement and possible accountability in the illegal drug activities. Joyce Ila, CNN Philippines.
Well, at the moment, Senator De Lima on her way home in a convoy accompanied by Senate security. But before that, she held a very brief news conference where she made a statement. Let's listen in.
And corresponding warrant of arrest, RTC Muntinlupa. Pero sa ngayon po, wala pa ho sa akin siniserve. Bagamat questionable yung pagkaka-issue ng warrant of arrest or ng order of arrest, questionable ho dahil dapat po bukas ay didinggin muna yung inihain ng aming mga abogado na motions to quash doon sa tatlong kaso. Sa katunayan, yung prosecution nga po, specifically DOJ, ay nagpa-postpone pa nga, nagpa-reset po nung hearing bukas for March 3. Kaya po, nagulat po kami lahat na biglang in-issue yung order of arrest and warrant of arrest. Katulad po ng nasabi ko na dati, wala po akong balak takasan yung mga kaso ko. Wala po akong balak magtago dahil haharapin ko po ang mga kaso na yan. Since ngayon po, at this very moment, 7:20, wala pa naman po nagsiserve ng warrant of arrest sa akin, ninanais ko muna po na umuwi muna para makapiling ko na muna po. Ang aking pamilya. At para kunin ko na po yung mga dadalhin kong gamit sa kulungan. So uuwi po ako ngayong gabi at babalik po ako dito bukas na umaga.
Portion of that brief statement given by Senator Lila de Lima shortly before she left. At the moment, we understand that her convoy is in the Sucat Skyway area, South Luzon Expressway. She's on her way home. She said she wanted to spend her last night of freedom with her family and to prepare her things, pack her things for detention. She also said that she would be returning to the Senate tomorrow morning so that she could wait there for her for the arresting officers who would bring that warrant of arrest that was issued at 5 o'clock this afternoon by the judge Juanita Tomas Guerrero of Branch 204 of the Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court. The case, criminal case 17-165, drug charges filed by the Department of Justice against Senator Lila de Lima. This has been CNN Philippines Breaking News. I'm Pia Ontiveros.